Good evening and welcome to Tinker Tailor Solder Fry, the Let's Try program here on the Mighty Loading Ready Live Video Entertainment Network. My name is Ian Horner, your host, and joining me today
is Ben. It's me, Bengineering. Mm-hmm. How's it going, friends?
Yeah, it's going to be a good time tonight.
Yeah, I've never been on this show.
It's a night of firsts because you've never been on a show.
Yeah.
You've also never done what we're about to do tonight.
Yeah.
And what is that?
We're going to put this totem pole
inside
of this monolith.
This sarcophagus here?
Yeah.
Okay. We're building a PC again tonight. It's the second time we've done this on the show, but I think it's still always a fun... It's one of my favorite things to do is put together hardware into a configuration that actually works.
Yeah, I mean, I'm super fortunate that I have people like you in my life that are able to put together stuff like this, because my first reaction was I looked at this stuff and was like, this is a computer right here, like this. So I mean, I don't know, just like all the different parts, like I was saying when they were doing the reveal, that like this just looks like a ruler and a X-Acto knife. Yep. Fornicated, and this is what came out.
That's unfortunately a lot of what computer equipment looks like these days.
Yeah. It's just different lengths of ruler.
A combination of sneakers, angry edges.
Right.
But we got to give a quick shout out to Tex and Reverend for providing you with all these pieces of equipment.
So. Yeah. Tex and Reverend, thank you so much. You've just been like a huge, like, helpful entity to like both Loading Ready Run and like the Loading Ready Run community and stuff. It kind of came out of nowhere. I mean, for any of you who don't kind of know the story for like months, Tex and Reverend had been asked, because I've never owned a PC before, and Tex and Reverend had been wanting to help me build a spec list, and I ran a big donation train on my stream, and we hit it, and I was like, cool, I'm all ready for that spec list. He's like, oh yeah, just a minute. And it turns out that he had already compiled all this stuff like months ago. He was already going for it. So so much love to Tex and Reverend. Thank you.
Massive amounts of generosity, massive thanks, especially for all you've done for us and for us here on the show.
Yeah, definitely.
Safety equipment, which hopefully we won't need tonight.
I mean, like this being the first time of me being on the show, I was reading like the chat pre-show, and I was just like, careful, just be careful. Yeah. It's like the reoccurring theme.
Shall we get started here?
Yeah, okay, yeah. What do we do?
Well,
we bring the monolith in.
Go nuts.
All right, so my first reaction is, I'm sure we did this from like top was what we needed to put in first.
Oh.
Right? So the rulers go like...
Yeah, in the box.
Right,
there
like
we go.
There.
Good, good.
And then...
So far, so good.
The box... I mean, there's only so many openings.
I mean, there's a cord back here that you might be able
to... Oh, good. Yeah.
Plug that into there. So maybe we just plug
like that
in there.
This says crucial on it, so this is probably the important part.
It's very crucial.
So we just put that in the
right
slot.
Right in the slot there.
Okay.
Yeah. And
so we're like halfway done already.
Well, I mean, you're really done. Those are all optional parts. Why don't you hit the button and see if we're good to go?
It's up here.
Yeah, okay, good.
Not quite.
No. Okay.
All right.
Well, okay. Let's...
Jokes! Better!
We're bad at what we do.
All right.
Yeah. So. No, you guys, the problem you're running into here, you got to use the hot glue gun.
Right.
Otherwise, it just rattles around like that. It's not safe.
Well, the crucial part is still in there, and that's what's important.
Yes, that's going
to
be in there
always be with this.
So we're going to have to break this open here. What you probably want to get started with is taking your side panels off here.
Okay, so that's these little...
Yeah, let's turn that around to face the camera.
Yeah.
See, the problem with doing things in this show is that we have to do it awkwardly.
Yeah. So. I mean, isn't that just life, though? Just a series of doing things awkwardly.
And I don't think they come all the way out, actually.
Okay.
On some cases like this, which are fancy...
They just come right off.
Yeah, and that way you don't lose them.
Okay.
And then you pull the panel back like that, and then it's going to pop off the side.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
See, I'm very, like anxious because it's so shiny and white.
Yeah.
I worry about like getting
I'll hold on to this for you so we don't put them in a place where they won't get marked.
Whoa, look at all the bits.
The bits.
So do all cases generally come with like all that, oh God. Hey, we found the crucial part. they generally come with all these doohickeys inside?
Yeah, I mean this is, the doohickeys that you're looking at in here are these cables. right. are going to attach to your motherboard in various places.
Okay.
So that they'll, this looks like it's the, well, it says right on HD audio.
Perfect.
So that's your audio.
Right, okay, not the video.
This one here, this blue one. Mm-hmm. Twist it. Oh, there we go. Yes. That blue one's your USB.
Right.
It's blue, so it's probably USB 3.
Okay.
These ones are labeled too.
Say power SW.
Mm-hmm.
And
HUDid light.
And HUDid light.
Yep.
All right.
And there's a third one in there too. That's probably.
Okay. And there's a bunch of other doohickeys back here, yep. but.
We'll get into that.
Yeah.
No, I wonder if there's anything else that needs. There we go.
Okay. Oh, it's a fan. Look at this, the guy.
Let's get everything off the front there.
It goes, woo.
Okay, now let's lay it down on its side.
Like this?
Yep,
this
way? This is probably going to be easier to get things into it that way to start with.
All right.
And let's take out the accessory box.
Oh, man.
So like Christmas.
Is this like sweet like decals that I get to put on the side? Can I put like a Valkyrie with like two wolves?
Just a sweet ass.
I want it to be like a sweet like Rush band.
Wizard on the side of your, yeah.
Okay, so it's got these like fly swatter type deals.
Okay, those look like they'll go on the top here.
Okay.
So they'll be, if we had fans up top.
Right.
You could use those
as like filters?
Yeah, filters.
Oh, okay. Cool.
I don't think we need those right yet or ever.
What else we got inside? We've got screws and twisty zop straps.
Zippity whiz bangs.
So these will be important, I assume.
For with to do your cable management.
Yeah, I mean, and then there's also it looks like extra little dealies for the end to screw on.
Oh, those actually for your hard drives too.
Oh, okay, cool. So just a plethora of good shiz.
Yeah.
And then it looks like instructions.
Those are good to follow.
We don't need these. Maybe we need these.
No, they were good to follow.
Yeah. Okay. Most of this is just like warnings and stuff. So, okay.
But yeah, unlike Kate's case, you've got a lot more room to work with in here.
Yeah, so I mean, I didn't really have like super big size requirements. I actually have a desk that has like that little tower shape on it, so.
So I think the first thing to do, let's bring this back up.
Okay.
It's much lighter now, and let's pull these cables out.
All right.
Make sure they're not getting caught on anything. And that way we've got more room inside the motherboard to work with and...
Right.
Oh, so let's show that off.
Ooh, it's got like a little...
Yeah. For the cable management on the back here, nice Velcro straps to carry your various components around in.
Very swank.
Yeah. I'm impressed with the workmanship we got here. Not sure what that is. Anyway,
that's what I want to hear.
never seen one of those damn before. So step one, we're probably going to want to get your power supply in here.
That's this big black one, right?
Yes.
All right. So the power supply that we've got is the 600 GQ.
Mm-hmm.
650 GQ.
From EVGA, other power supplies are available.
Yeah. Do we have a knife?
We should get a knife and probably a crosshead screwdriver.
All right.
Crosshead?
Yes. Phillips is the correct word for it.
So what is like, so 650 watts, that's like a decent amount of power, I would imagine.
I mean, given what processors take these days, 650 watts is quite sufficient.
Yeah. Cool.
I think Jeff Atwood was talking about in some of his builds, he's managed to get computers running that are draw less than 100 watts at a load.
Oh, okay. So this is quite up there then.
Yeah. Which means that in some cases you can have a computer that takes less energy than your light bulbs.
Really?
Well, I mean, yeah, Ben, speaking as a lighting guy.
Yeah.
What does 650 watts say to you? Is that like a lot? That doesn't seem like that much in terms of lighting.
If you're using like straight up like actual bulbs and whatnot, like a single Leco like stage light, those can go up to 750 watts. Generally, like the ones you'll see, maybe if you go to like your local theater, those will be about 575.
But you'd be running like. Three or four of those on one, or a bunch of them on those. Same.
Well, like the most generally, like you can like twofer a couple together, kind of a thing. But yeah, like I it's especially in terms of like theater production. Sometimes if you have like each light on its own circuit, it makes it a lot easier when you're, say, like patching it into your lighting board, because then that circuit itself can correspond to a channel on your board, right? And then you can have each one separately doing a cool thing, which is a lot of fun.
So what you're saying is this would not be the power supply to go for
for
a theatrical lighting set.
No.
All right.
Yeah, we bring in the big dimmer boxes and stuff. I think
so
I can actually.
You say it's a bit beefy for the PC, but the beef is there for.
Still tracking down a screwdriver.
It'll be in the gray case.
I managed to get the tape off. I think we'll be good there.
It's. The extra beef is going to be for your graphics card.
Oh, okay.
They still draw quite a bit of power.
Quite a bit of power.
And future-proofing, too.
All right, so inside, we've got this big boy.
And a bunch of cables.
Yeah,
and once again, Texan coming through with the good stuff.
One of these work for you?
Sure.
What happened to the screwdriver someone sent you?
Yeah, specifically Texan.
They're by the gray case where my other screwdrivers are.
Home?
No, on the floor in the equipment office. Yeah, there's a gray case that looks like a briefcase.
Damn, they smell really nice.
So yeah, as I said, he sent you the good stuff because that's a modular power supply, meaning that you only have to plug in the cables you need.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Those are also not going to be.
You need them,
yeah, these are not going to work for me today.
For you
Thank
now.
You so much for them, Texan. They are going to be perfect for what we're. Yeah, this, in the future.
This stream, especially.
They are too small. Thank you, Graham.
Nice. All right. Now we're ready.
Okay. Probably won't need these much at all. So this is going to go in this hole back here.
In the very bottom there?
Yes. But you don't come in from this angle.
You come in from there.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so.
Let's flip this side back up.
Yeah. Cool.
And maybe point that in towards there and clear this out.
Okay, so I assume we want the side with the power out.
Yes.
Maybe this way?
Yep.
Yeah, that looks about right side out.
Yes, because you want the fan to be able to vent out.
Right.
Into the venting area.
The bottom, then?
Yep.
Is that where the, yeah, cool.
Perfect.
Yeah, we did it. Okay, and I assume then we need to screw it on.
Do you have some screws in there? Yes, you
Yes, do. We do.
Great.
Okay.
So do you want to screw or do you want to hold it up?
I can hold it up.
Great.
Sure. See, this is really cool too because I imagine there's probably a couple people like me who just like straight up have no idea when it comes to this kind of stuff. So like, hopefully this is beneficial for you guys as well because I am certainly learning a lot. Yeah.
Okay.
Is that good?
It is close. There we go. And just up a little bit farther. Haha.
Wicked.
There we go. Okay, and get the other one in, and this will be much easier.
I mean, it seems like at this point a lot of, like especially just the way that this case is kind of, the building process seems very streamlined in that kind of way. Am I right in saying that?
Yeah,
or
I mean,
is each like I imagine each is its own, you know, horse of a different color.
But. Often said, like with most computer building stuff these days, mm-hmm. everything's so different that if it doesn't go in, if you have to force it,
right.
you're probably doing it wrong.
Right. I mean, that could be said about a lot of things.
And there's only a couple points where it's very vital to not push very hard.
Right.
I feel like. Ian saying, if you have to force it, you're probably doing it wrong. It's going to come back to bite him at some point.
Probably.
If not tonight, then in the future. Let's just keep that quote
keep
ready.
Keep that one in mind.
Yeah.
Ready, okay. Just in case we need it.
Okay, now you can push your power supply cable through one of these holes, but I'm not sure which one we want to use just yet. So let's just keep that at the ready.
Okay. All right.
Until we get the motherboard in.
Okay, so that's this guy right here, right?
Yep.
The ultra durable.
It's one thing that I do like about, I mean, you know, you're talking about how, you know, there's all the different sizes of things and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But it's interesting that computer cases, especially PC cases like this, are united by, it's like nobody can agree on what size things should be, what shape things should be, how many ports it should have, yada, yada, yada. But one thing, they finally worked out where the holes for the screws have to be.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. And so that's the only thing. And so it's like, okay, you know, everything will be different, but the holes will be in the right
place.
As
long as they're lining up, you're good.
Yeah. So they'll line up, and we can make the cases, and we can make the holes. We can make the motherboards and everything. Right. We'll know that they'll sort of fit anyway.
Standardized hole position.
So we've got the H97N Wi-Fi. Is that the actual name of it?
It's ultra durable.
It's the ultra durable motherboard. Looks really trippy. See, like, okay, when I was a kid, I'm actually surprised I remember this. When I was a kid, he took me to the computer store.
to see the marching ants?
Basically, whenever I looked at these, I thought, like, it would be very cool if there was a PBS children's TV show about kids going in to like here and learning how like computers work mm-hmm. and whatnot, a la, you know, like Magic School Bus style. I don't know. I just thought that was a fun, tidbit. Things that I
the
thought
the modern version of that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Like, because for people like me who know nothing. So
do you have any questions first of all about what's going on here?
Okay. So the backside of this seems like what I know, right? Because this is the stuff that just like pokes out. So you've got like your audio dealies, your USB dealies. Mm-hmm. This is like old timey keyboard mouse shit. Yeah.
Some people think that it's better for gaming.
Oh really?
Yes.
Oh okay. Yeah. And then like. I assume Ethernet type deals, HDMI.
There are two Ethernets, which is DVI. Pretty nifty.
Yeah.
So you can you can be like us here at One Ready to run two different internet providers.
Oh, dang. Well, I got that. I got that Shaw 150 good shit.
Mm. Yeah, but what happens if Shaw goes down?
That's true, as they do.
Let's stick that down here. What else is in your motherboard there?
What else is in my mother?
The weird thing, I have actually a very similar motherboard. I don't know if it's the same one, but a similar one with two cards like that. But they actually are different. Like they each one, they use two different drivers.
Yeah, right. One's like Intel and then one will be VR.
Yeah, yeah. They'll actually like, it's because there's like the ones that are made for the card and then one that are like standard.
Yeah,
and then the motherboard company adds another one.
Yeah, usually one's actually part of the Intel chipset, mm-hmm. which is standard, so why not put the board on?
Okay. So we got this, which I assume has to deal with the Wi-Fi's.
Yes, you'll use that later to plug in your Wi-Fi's.
All right,
if you want to use the Wi-Fi's.
Yeah, like I mean, I've got the hard line, which I'll probably always use, but is it... It's probably obviously not hurting it to have it in and all that jazz. So we've got that. We've also got this.
Ah, those are going to be super important very soon.
Sorry, no, Heather's like trying to get the bead on it.
Those are your SATA cables.
Okay.
Serial ATA. So
all right.
That your computer can talk to its hard drives.
That sounds important.
it's vital.
Okay.
One might say it's crucial.
All right, so...
We'll need those in a bit.
Okay. And then, this looks like the facing.
This is kind of weird, though, that they decided that they're going to give you two different cables, one that has two straight ends on it, and one that has one straight end and one 90-degree end. And I guess that's...
So do you only need one?
Oh, no, you need both.
Okay.
Because you've got two hard drives.
Right.
But I'm just... I guess they gave you one of each because maybe... You don't.
Can they?
Maybe one of them needs to be right angle. Yeah.
Interesting.
But
weird. And then it looks like we've got the facing. Uh-huh. I imagine this is the outer portion.
Text and reference says the even if you're not using the Wi-Fi, that built into that is also the Bluetooth.
Oh, it has Bluetooth.
Wow. So if you want to use, you know, a PS4 controller or something.
So you'll want to probably
absolutely
install that.
Yes. All right. So there's the very shiny. Very neat. It's got the graphite details. okay.
Fancy time. So that's going to be the first thing you need to put in.
Right.
Where do you think that goes?
Well, where's the back of this Jim Jammy? This side, mm-hmm. probably, okay. right? So, right there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yay.
I know things. So.
Which side goes down? This is one of those things where they haven't actually made it. They have made it possible to screw up.
Like this?
Looks right.
I guess. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Sorry, I'm putting you on the spot here.
No. This is exactly how I learn. I like to be thrown into the fire. This snapped right.
Feels like it.
That looks good.
Sounds like it.
Oh.
He mostly got it. It's missing an edge. Let's give you that there.
Aha!
There we go.
There we go. Just like a Lego.
Yep. And you didn't have to force it.
Yeah, we're not at that point yet.
Okay, so are there any screws in there?
That's
my question.
No.
Okay.
There are zero screws.
We'll probably have to use some of the screws that came with the
motherboard
or the case itself. As for the trash, we can just dispose of that for the moment.
We'll make you clean it up later.
Yeah, probably.
There we are. Right,
these guys.
Yes.
Okay.
Empty whiz bangs.
So, what do we need here? Just a couple of.
Yeah. Let's dump those out and have a look at what we got.
So we've got all these dealies.
Those ones. Two
bunch of screws.
Big.
We've got these skinny boys here.
So we're probably gonna want
these dudes. and then even tinier ones.
There we go. So we're probably gonna want to use let's see here. Say these guys here, the hex-topped ones.
Unlike most assembly projects, with computers, it's not necessarily bad if you end up with screws
missing.
extra at the end.
Right.
They give you more than you need.
It's on purpose, yeah.
I'm actually going to say we use these guys, the flat-toppy ones.
Okay.
We'll need a few of those, so we'll have them ready. Yeah, so this is the motherboard. Let's get it lined up in there.
Right.
Because there are a number of screws. Actually, I should let you do this.
Okay.
So
it just fits into
the thing
the
to be
holes.
Careful of here is mm-hmm. this fan cable.
Right.
Make sure that's over top of the motherboard.
Yeah.
Match up the holes in the motherboard to those little stands. And try not to scrape too much. I think you're just about there.
Do you have the standoffs already in there?
Yeah, standoffs are on the motherboard.
Oh, nice.
There they are. So there's going to be some resistance from the back plate just because that keeps it stiff.
Right.
Let me get the rover cam.
Maybe you can see what's going on.
Yeah.
That looks pretty good. And then we just...
How's that? Whoop. Okay.
Let me know when you're going to stop, when you stop moving it. And I'll switch to it.
I have nearly stopped moving it. How about that?
Okay.
There we go.
Great.
Nice.
It's a view.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll need one. Let's start with one screw in there. So we want one of those ones.
All right.
Yeah. Yep. And let's get nice. Let you get one there.
Sure.
Get your hands dirty. good call there.
There we go.
Let's adjust that to you.
I thought it was a magnetic screwdriver.
Oh, I mean, usually it would be for me, but the chat has definitely chastised me for that in the past.
Oh, for using magnets around computers?
Which is not a problem.
Okay, well, I mean, I don't know any different. I'll believe you, because you're in the room. getting this guy here.
Yeah, this is a very small motherboard.
Yeah, are they generally quite a bit bigger?
Generally, yeah. Well,
let's... I mean, it's actually kind of interesting because the places where a lot of the things on the back of the motherboard are, are set,
right?
Like are kind of locked in.
Mm-hmm.
But the rest of the motherboard isn't. So you can, if you've got a bigger motherboard, all the stuff that sticks out the back of the computer would actually be mostly the same. But there'd just be more other stuff.
Right.
Yep.
Cool.
And you get a smaller motherboard, and again, that actual little piece that sticks out the back of the computer would be largely the same, but there'd just be a lot less other bits.
Okay.
This is going to be interesting, too, because let's open up your graphics card.
All right.
I want to make sure that it's going to actually...
All right, now.
No, I'm going to trust it does.
Yeah, I mean, Texan knows what he's doing. So we got the Zotac GeForce GTX 1060. Mm-hmm.
Also, for those asking, specifically Shalakitty, TTSF is not sponsored by Wormwood. Liberty Run as a whole has an agreement with Wormwood.
Let's do a shout out to them.
Yeah, if you're interested in picking up any Wormwood accessories over the holiday season, they will not arrive by the holidays. We want to put that up very close, but you can still get free shipping by entering the code LOADINGREADYRUN, or LRR, for free shipping. Anywhere else in the world, use LRR WORLD to save $10 off your order.
All right. These discs are probably important. Okay.
I mean, they're probably old, though.
Yeah, oh, so like going online for the drivers is probably the best bet, eh?
Okay. Whew, that's a big boy.
Man.
Big thick boy.
This looks important.
So what you're going to want to do is, we're not going to actually install it yet, but just line the slot up with the slot here.
Okay.
And probably. We're just going to look to see if that. Okay, good. So that does match up with your holes there.
Does it?
Yeah.
Oh, with the holes on here.
Yeah, with these two card slots.
Okay, because it looks like the actual things don't quite match up.
They do.
Are they well? All right.
Trust
me. I trust you, man.
Trust us on that.
I don't know anything. Cool.
Okay. Next up, I think we're going to want to plug in some of the cables.
All right.
Not all the cables, but some of the ones that'll be harder to get to once we get the CPU in there.
Do you have an idea of which ones?
Yeah.
We're already almost at the point where, but and soon we'll be definitely at the point that, because where the graphics card actually is bigger than the mother, like, because motherboards keep shrinking and graphics card keeps getting bigger.
Right.
And so if you've got one of the more heavy-duty graphics cards and a smaller motherboard, it's entirely possible you will have a bigger motherboard or bigger graphics card with a bigger processor and more RAM than your actual computer.
I see a couple of people in chat saying you could fit a whole other computer in this case.
You really could. It's kind of amazing.
I'm happy.
Mm-hmm. So what we're looking at here at this point is all these connectors need to get connected up to the motherboard.
Okay.
So now we want to decide where we want to fire them through.
Do we want to? I can hold this maybe. Oh yeah.
Yeah. I mean, sure. It's what is this?
Or we can flip it. I don't know.
Connect this connector with Fanatics multicolor LED strips only. Okay. So we don't use that because we don't have any of those Fanatics.
Cool. What's a Fanatic?
A case manufacturer.
Okay. Oh, that's no, this case manufacturer.
You've got no fancy LED lighting strips?
No, but I mean, maybe that's a thing in the future. I think the main thing, too, is, and I didn't quite address it, too, at the start, one of the ideas for this case, because my quote-unquote brand has kind of become, like, Plaid. My friend TQ has actually offered to paint the sides in Plaid.
Oh, nice. So you deliberately got a plain, plain white.
Yeah, so it's gonna be a Plaid desktop, which just feels good. I'm super stoked to see how it goes.
Your brand.
My brand.
So yeah, I think we will want to take.
You should just like wrap the panels in flannel.
Yeah. Well, then I mean we could get like Plaid LED.
The flannel like, set up. Panel.
Plaid LEDs. How does that work?
I'll just get like a gobo or something and just always have it going.
So I see what's going on here. This is your fan connector here.
Yeah.
And then it goes to front. It looks like. Yep. Okay. So that's good. And then these, I guess, are for more fans. Mm-hmm. So we're going to need this connected somehow.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, come to think of it, flannel, known for its heat retaining properties, may not be the best.
The best idea.
Yeah.
So this...
you can make your computer into a Snuggie.
That's what everybody wants.
So I know this is a type of motherboard connector, and your motherboard does not appear to have it.
Oh, all right.
Yep. So that's okay. Not all motherboards do.
Okay.
Most of mine don't, but the one I'm
working with. We haven't hit problem status.
No, not at all yet.
Wicked.
Next up.
Yes.
Let's get your switches on there. Do we want to do that? Those look like they're pretty close to the front, so we can do that later. I'm thinking about this secondary. See this connector here?
Mm-hmm.
On the mother.
Sorry, what?
That connector there?
Yes.
That one we'll probably want to connect, and that, I think, comes off the power supply.
Okay.
Now that's... CPU1. So we're going to need one of your special cables.
Blargent points out that there is 100% space for a Beyblade arena inside your case.
Nice. Why wouldn't I do that? So are these all the same? Oh, and actually it does come with an IEC.
Good.
So
people are saying they want us to deal with the RAM and CPU first. I feel it's easier to actually get with, especially with these fiddly little pins in here. Along the edge, it's probably going to be easier to get those in before we install the RAM.
Mm-hmm.
And the CPU, I think these pins along the side here, again, probably easier to get in, get dealt with before we put the CPU in.
Okay.
So let's do that.
Okay, so which one?
Well, have a look on them. One of them should say CPU. It's not going to be any of those.
All right, screw you. This says CPU.
Great.
Wicked.
Let's take that one.
All right. So, oh, they're a bunch. Yeah. All right. So this says CPU. It's got a big dealy and two little dealies.
Okay, so stick the big dealy in one of the CPU clickers there.
Okay.
Maybe I'll get the webcam over there. I think we're at the stage where it's too easy. Too easy for Ben to click it in. Or not.
I mean, it feels in.
Yeah, is it coming out?
No.
Then it's in.
All right.
Okay. Ooh. And again, that's going to come up into that thing there. So route your cable appropriately. I would probably guess around there and then...
And then through here, probably?
I mean, I'd go up actually even down up through there.
All right, let's do that. I trust in the expertise.
So we'll clean up your cabling.
Mm-hmm. Once
we've got
cabled.
Some more stuff in there.
Yeah. Let's make sure though that it lies nice and flat.
Mm-hmm.
And then
doing good,
I can't walk around because microphones. But we can do it this way. So does it matter which of these little dealies?
Use one just for fun.
Alright.
Okay, then either should be fine.
They don't have a number on them, so.
Now, that's one of those cables that's only going to go in one way, so.
There
perfect.
We go.
You got it.
I have a CPU.
Okay. I have a pineapple.
Pineapple CPU.
CPU ruined.
My least favorite meme.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. It's not like I'm just like, how could you?
Yeah, so the big deal one here is the CPU fan that we're going to want to get in there as well.
Okay.
But
that was those other ones that I was holding before?
I'm thinking at this point, though, we might want to actually go ahead and just get the CPU in there first.
Sure.
Just planning things out.
All right,
we're trying to. Okay, this is the scariest part.
Oh, good.
Okay.
I'm ready, coach.
Crack open that blue box.
This one.
Yep.
Oh, this is the... Okay, so this was the thing that I was really confused. It's a gigantic box, but I hear all you need is this little top chippy. So what's the rest of this box for?
Well, some of the CPUs come with their own cooler. Like this one does, in fact. But we're not going to use that, so you can just keep that in there.
Screw you, big thing. So this is where all the brain, this is the brain.
And just cover that back up there, because that gray stuff is goopy.
Oh, okay.
We don't want to get that on. Well, we do want to get it on certain things, but not on that.
Okay, so.
So before you get that out.
All right, let's put that away.
We need to find a place for it.
Right.
And that place is right here.
Okay.
Again, this is going to be.
Place found.
Nope, I pushed the button. I'm very sorry, Paul. Okay, the camera is in place.
Cool.
That place is right here.
Right.
It goes under that plastic bit, which means we're going to need to get that plastic bit out of there. Yeah. Yep, just like that. I'm so sorry.
Just the way it's like, oh, God.
Yeah, This is the area where you do need to be careful, though.
Okay, yeah. I will wait for your specific instructions.
You can't do anything wrong, but okay. These pins are very delicate, so don't go mashing things around.
Yes, absolutely.
So what we're going to want to do is get this out of here somehow. That little lever, if you push it down and pull it out, it will pop up.
Right.
Yeah. Keep pulling. There we go. And flip it up. And then flip the whole thing. There you go.
Okay.
Great. That's the cage where we keep the CPU.
Right.
So the CPU doesn't escape.
Exactly.
It doesn't.
It's going to be very. It's going to be very angry with what you do with it later. So
right.
It's
yeah. Leave. That's fair. Okay.
Now there is a way to put in the CPU.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll note that there are a couple tabs here.
Yes.
And here.
Yes.
You'll note corresponding tabs on the CPU. They'll be along the edges of the green circuit board.
Right.
So flip it over again.
Okay, like here?
Yeah, because you're going
to... This is how it's going to go down, like this way, or...?
See the tab there and there on those sides?
Yeah.
Those are going to line up with those two tabs, so you need to twist it 90 degrees like that. They'll go in like that.
And then it falls in like this.
I mean, yeah, there's also... You'll notice one corner is cut off.
Right, yes. Phone going nuts.
Or at least has a triangle.
Right. And so it just...
Yep. Just falls in there. Think you got it? Yeah, that looks right. Is it... perfect.
Yeah.
You did a good job.
All right.
Okay, so flip the big metal cage back on top. And then do the lever thing.
Pull the lever, crunk.
Hold on. Yeah, there we go. Because that little bit is going to go underneath the screw.
Right.
Oh, that sound.
All right. Yes. We did it.
This is known as the zero insertion force.
Yes.
Which is true about the processor, but then there's a thing that you have to clamp on to the processor, which kind of defeats the whole zero
insertion force.
Right. Okay.
The hold down section, not so much. Okay. Now.
That was the hard part.
Yeah,
the rest is all downhill.
Pretty much.
Nice. I can deal with that.
Now we should probably think about getting those other pin bit on there.
Okay.
So let's do that.
All right.
Flip it back up.
I love the idea of like a series of like YouTube ASMR videos that's just people inserting CPUs really slowly.
So this is your HD audio bracket.
Right.
You'll notice it's colored.
Yes.
Do you see anything in here that matches the colors or might
right
say,
there? Yay! Oh my goodness. Were you double-checking to make sure it wasn't...
Yeah, that's not the right one.
Oh, is it not?
No.
But it's got colors.
But what does it say underneath it?
F-panel.
Right. And what does this say over here?
F-audio.
Right.
But it's not color-coded at all.
I know.
Man, you lied. Or was the look, they're nice and color-coded. Now, where would that be? That was just like a...
Total fake-out.
Yeah.
So that needs to go down into that area there.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just stick that through.
Right.
We can get to it. Go, go, go. We can pull the slack out later. This needs to go in, because that's your front USB.
Okay.
Where do you think that goes?
Front USB, right there.
There we go,
Yeah. Oh, so it's both of these things.
That's going to go just in that box there.
Oh, okay, that's what that corresponds to. Neat.
Yep.
Cool.
So that one, maybe we should send up either through here. Ooh, that's fun.
Oh, is it like rubber? Oh, it's like rubbery.
Or we could send it through here. I like going through those things just because they have them.
Yeah, totally.
And then we can send that through.
Use the rubber hole when you can.
Yep. Good life advice. This looks like the fan.
Mm-hmm.
So let's put it up into the fan area.
Okay. Fan town.
Fan wheel.
The fan zone.
Send that up.
So because I noticed that we also have a cooling thing. Do you use the cooling thing in conjunction with the two fans that are already?
No, I don't. That does look like it has a fan on it, so I think so. I think we'll have to find a way of plugging that in.
Okay. All right.
And then we got these two guys.
Right.
Power switch, reset switch, and HDD LED.
Okay.
Those go to your front panel thing up front here. So let's send those through the hole.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Okay. And that looks like that's just about everything. I think these are our lighting rigs.
Cool.
But I could be wrong. They might also be extra fan connectors. We'll find out after this. No. And this is your power supply.
That's probably the most important thing.
We should also get that in there.
Okay.
So if you're going to use the hole, we could use that. I mean, there's space here for it, but the hole makes things cleaner.
Mm-hmm. Give birth to life.
That hole under the slot underneath that is not, that's only, that would normally be covered if you had a normal size.
Like a larger motherboard,
Let's actually just give you a taste of it here. A larger motherboard extends to all these holes.
Okay. Cool. All right, so now we got to do the hookups.
Yeah, so.
This guy probably plugs in here.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. How we doing?
So far, so good.
All right.
I think you might have it upside down.
Ah!
Congratulations, you have an ATX connector. It's a boy.
It's a boy.
Well, one end is.
Yeah. Do I?
Ah, so you've got an ATX connector that looks like it's big and needs the X to end there.
The what?
You'll need the full width of that ATX connector.
Okay. I have to plug them in at the same time. Oh, okay, so maybe it'll be better for me to...
I think you're still backwards, though, because you've got your clip on this end.
Right.
And you've got your edge for a clip on that end.
Right. So, using...
The power of your mind.
The power of my mind will do that. Fuck.
It's sometimes easier to actually hook them together before you...
This is how we learn it.
There.
Hey.
That sounded good.
Great.
Okay.
Nice solid click there. All right. What do we want to do next? I think now we want to actually get your... let's deal with the other things that need to go on there.
Mm-hmm. So all the other cables we push through.
As somebody in the chat says, and that's my experience too, I have literally never seen... any computer that doesn't use that extra little 4-pin block.
Yeah.
I don't know why but for some reason, I guess there are some that don't.
Okay.
You always have to use it.
Where's the manual for your case there? I want to make sure of what that wire is. I think it might be one of the ones you tossed away.
This is why we don't toss things around the room then.
I put it back on the table, I recall. There we are.
So let's have a look at what it says to do. We should actually get PDFs of this for the next time.
Mm-hmm.
Front panel. USB. Microphone, though.
Are you on the Spanish ones?
Drop and lock. Nice.
Befestien se das Nestiel mit den Miguel Leferten Schrauben.
Yep, this is of no help.
Okay.
Okay, well, we'll find out if we've got any empty connectors later.
Sure.
But I'm pretty sure this needs to get connected in somewhere. But I know that needs a fan. So we're going to get that in connected next, your heat sink.
We don't want to plug in all the... Or is it just because we probably want to plug in after?
Yeah, we can do that now.
Okay.
Okay, and this is where we're going to need some help from here.
Okay.
Maybe.
Or do you want the motherboard one, maybe?
No, the motherboard one... Yeah, that would help, actually.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait. So for the switches, it doesn't really matter much. They can just be... because they're momentary switches.
Right.
But the one that matters, the polarity, is the HDD light.
Okay.
So, yeah, you can...
You'll want to find out on the motherboard which one of these is the HDD light, which one is the switch, and which one is the reset button.
Okay, how do I do that? In here?
Yep.
All right.
Oh, wait. That's for your power supply.
That's my power supply.
That's probably just a lot of warranty information.
That's a processor. This is the graphics card. That's the motherboard. I don't know.
You're going to end up with a lot of manuals that you never, ever look at.
Yeah.
Here we go. Multilingual instruction booklet.
That's me.
Let's see if I can help you out.
Okay. Maybe chat knows.
Yeah, also, these disks are not really that relevant to you, given that you don't actually have a CD drive.
Installation einer CPU und ein CPU coolers. I think I'm on the...
It's funny because we don't speak German.
Yeah.
A couple people were saying that that some motherboards come with a little sled that like you connect, you put all those connectors into, and then it connects them all together.
Mm-hmm. What was this? Kate's PC had one. This one
does not appear.
Doesn't seem to have one.
So wait, what am I looking for?
Wait a second. Unless I was wrong. No, that's the HD audio. That's right. That goes over there.
Okay.
We're looking for... Here
Texan Reverend says it has no sled.
This is what we're looking for here.
Okay.
Not the F audio, but the F panel. So you can see that connects there. 10 has no pin. 10 has no pin.
Okay.
So reset and... So reset's going to be between pins that side. So your power switch is going to be these two pins here, next to the one that's not connected in.
So this one? These two right here?
Let me point for you. This one and this one.
Wait, like diagonal?
the top two.
Oh.
Let me point for you on the manual. This one and this
one. Okay, so like so. Yeah.
And then, yes, correct.
Cool.
And the power LED will be the next two down.
Okay. That's what this
now,
is.
Yes. Is that one of the polarity ones? I believe it is. Yeah, so it's got plus and minus.
Mm-hmm.
And that is your that's your HDD light. So that's the bottom. Plus is to the left. So.
Okay, so to the left. So it'd be facing that way.
Tilt the webcam down just a little
slightly?
Bit so
sure.
You can see it. See the pins you're talking about?
Maybe move that manual.
Yeah, that's where we
there
are.
There you go. Let me get the focus here.
Okay, so.
Yeah, so pin one, so if that's the one with no pin.
Right.
Plus is going to be that one, and minus is going to be that side. See, as you can see on the thing, plus is.
Oh, I see.
So I guess label side out. Label side towards you.
Oh, towards me.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
Thrilling.
Ta-da!
Okay. And then finally, the reset switch.
Does go on
this? This is kind of like
we'll be right next.
Keep talking and no one explodes.
Yeah. Yeah,
we'll be right next to the hard drive one.
That was the first one we did?
Nope.
That was the one we just did.
Right next to this one.
Okay, does it matter which way?
That one doesn't matter. No, and by next to it, I mean there.
Yes. Oops, sorry, camera.
This is why Lego instructions aren't just words, they're also pictures.
Yeah.
Now put a 2x2 block of red next to the 4x3 block.
All right. Cool.
Make sure they're directly adjacent.
So that went the opposite direction of the one beside it?
Because it's a switch, I don't think it matters. The polarity?
Uh-huh.
Because you're just bridging them. Now, I think we're missing one, because you should have a hard drive light, too. Somewhere. Generally. Unless this one doesn't have a hard drive light for some reason.
The webcam was...
Is it a good idea to have a webcam just banging around in there like that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's,
Whoops.
I'm baffled.
Yeah. I'm missing the power LED.
Yeah, you're right. Power LED is what we're missing.
Though I guess it just maybe doesn't need a power LED because it's sensing the power from something else. That could be the way it works.
A lot of if you actually look at the front of this case, does it actually have a hard drive light on the front of the case?
On the top, you've got this power, but it probably works based on its own system. Like if the case turns on, then it probably goes on. We'll find out when we get to the troubleshooting stage.
I would assume this light would turn on.
Yeah.
So.
As people in the chat are saying, it's amazing, those little, those weird little pins, especially if you're building a PC these days, might seem somewhat incongruous, like just kind of a weird, it's like when everything else are these connectors that kind of clunk in,
right.
There's these weird little pins.
Yeah.
And there's all these weird things on a motherboard that were basically designed, 70 years ago.
Yeah.
And nobody's bothered, not 70 years ago, in the 70s. Bothered to update it.
Yeah. These are the things that are...
Texan says, Ian, I believe the main LEDs at the bottom of the front face serve the power LED purpose. I don't think it has a normal power LED.
I think I just came to that conclusion too, so.
Cool.
Thank you for the confirmation.
Yeah.
Let's get your USB in.
Sure. That is the blue guy.
Yeah.
Right here.
That goes to the black connector with the slot, so you can't screw it up.
Ian, you have so much faith in me.
Yep, you had it in there, going in right.
I just don't want to force it.
Now check the number of pins, too. Yep, you're good. Oh, it's just a very tight box. There we go. Nice.
Cool. All right.
All right. Okay, now comes the scary part.
Man, you said it was all downhill from here.
Well, now we get to deal with the CPU.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think this is actually a good thing to do before we go to break?
Okay.
Let's make sure the camera's in there in a good position. All right, that thing that you're leaning on. Also, we probably shouldn't be leaning on the boxes. Everything's very robust.
Yes.
That thing that you're leaning on is now broken. So, great. Good job.
Okay, there's some screws.
Okay, screws, good. We have screws.
So we've got an M9 cryo rig.
Mm.
Which sounds pretty swank. Wow, look at this guy.
Okay, So the other thing we're gonna get out of there, maybe, is everything.
Is everything.
Good lord.
So there's a bunch of screws.
Yep. Plastic bits. Okay, these are the nuts for the.
There's a needle.
Yep, that's.
Is this the thing? The thermal paste.
Like I said, you're very stressed out right now. This is the heroin you're going to use to calm down once you've got everything in there.
Texan Reverend says RAM first.
RAM first.
I guess the cooler might block the slots.
Yeah, that might happen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you've done this before, so. RAM first.
All right. Oh, these are that's what the X-Acto knife rulers are.
The fan will have to come off the cooler to fit the RAM in.
That's bizarre.
It's a big ass fan, I guess.
Well, the RAM's
tiny motherboard.
The RAM's too big too. I have no love for these gigantic heat sinks on RAM these days.
It's cool.
It's completely unnecessary.
Guys. Dags.
Yeah.
There's two of them.
Yep.
Now, you know it's got to be fast.
Yeah.
Look at that.
It's got a sharp rip jaws.
Yeah, aerodynamicness is very important with your RAM.
You're going to want two hands for this.
Okay.
So check the bottom of the RAM.
Okay.
Make the note of where the slot is.
What's the slot?
There's a slot there, right?
Oh, it's got a little hole.
Which means that it probably matters which direction you put the slot in the motherboard.
So this way.
Yep. Before you do that, make sure that these mm-hmm. are clicked open.
Oh, all right.
This motherboard only clicks open on one side.
Right.
So sometimes there are two, sometimes there are one.
And it does is, oh, I guess there's only two.
Ooh.
Should it click?
You gotta push down on both sides.
The clip that you opened up should basically close by itself from the pressure of you putting down.
I think.
Everyone's saying hard.
Okay,
yeah. There it is.
Okay, so you get to do the next one.
Okay.
I should have done the one not facing the camera.
Yeah.
Now, did you match the slot, the notch?
They should be the same direction, yeah.
Good.
Yeah. It's called RAM for a reason.
Yeah. I like to give mine a good lick before I stick it in, just to make sure the contacts are all nice and moistened. Makes for better.
All right.
Nice. There we go.
It didn't go all the way.
Oh, just give it a nice... Go to the edges. And push there.
There.
There we go.
Cool.
All right, RAM's in.
Nice.
Now it's time for the...
The cool fan.
Yeah. Okay. Scary.
So, yeah. I shared this last time when we did Kate's build, but as a piece of information for if you're building your own computer, mm-hmm. when you're installing the RAM... don't just go by like when the little thing clicks on the side.
Mm-hmm.
On my computer, I had a big problem getting my computer running, and I was like really annoyed and taking out all the little pieces.
Yeah. Okay.
It turned out that my RAM was just not seated properly, but it had like clicked in. But then when I went and inspected it, it had not actually pushed all the way into the socket. So,
this is the manual, right?
Especially if you've got a small, like this case, you can see it no problem. But if you've got a small case where it's kind of dark inside, mm-hmm. it can be difficult to see that. So check it out.
Now flip that guy over, Ben, because that's what you're doing right now is resting it on what the chip is going to rest on.
Oh, okay.
And we want to make sure, okay, so it does not have any thermal paste on it. This will require a manual application of thermal paste.
I'm not going to do that.
This is your product registration card.
Okay.
It's in a special.
Nice.
A special package of its own.
Cool.
Wow.
In the box.
To stop static electricity getting on your product registration card.
I guess so. Okay, so here's all your stuff. In das.
This is a lot of stuff.
Aktung. Okay, these are neither of those are English language, so it must be the other one. All right, so you do not have an AMD, so we don't need to worry about that.
Mm-hmm.
But we could watch the video.
We should cue that up.
Okay, so we're going to want to get this mounting bar
mm-hmm.
on the bottom.
Oh, wow. This is
This is a very complex boy. You've got your metal clamps on the outside.
Oh, my goodness.
Jeez. This is a very involved one.
Maybe we should take a quick commercial break.
I think so.
Read the instructions and then come back.
Yeah, for sure.
I thought this would be fun to do before, but no, we need time.
Cool.
So we'll see you for more of Ben's build.
Yeah.
After this short commercial break.
Alrighty.
Okay, so we're going to need to cauterize the wound once it happens. Right. Welcome back to Tinker Tailor Soldier Fry, the Let's Try program here on the Mighty Loading Radio Y Video Entertainment Network. Tonight we're building Ben's PC, and we're just about to get the
cooler, yeah. the cryo rig M9.
Woof. It had me thrown for a loop because it came with a lot more parts than I'm used to.
Right.
On a heatsink.
Some heavy duty.
Specifically
shiz.
These parts, and I couldn't figure out where they went.
Right.
And it turns out they're extras.
Oh, good.
So that's
awesome.
That's all well and good. Yeah, these clips are just what hold the fan onto the front of the device.
So with this, I won't need to put ice packs on my computer.
No, anymore. You will never good. Need to do that again.
Good.
Is that God something would. That was happening?
Oh, yeah. Well, because it's like all my streaming and everything I was doing on a laptop. And it overheated when I was playing Stacking, the Tim Schafer game, which is very not, it's like CPU intensive at all. And it would overload during like Hearthstone. And so eventually I had two ice packs with me at all times that I had in like a little cooler, and I would swap them out throughout my stream. So.
Sweet.
Yeah.
So these are your.
All right, well, regardless of how this, the power of this computer, I think we can safely say that
it's
you won't need ice packs.
good.
No. that's the nice thing about these big tower PCs is they've got lots of space for internal ice packs.
Yeah.
So this is your mounting bar.
Okay.
And this is what that actually mounts to.
Right.
So what we're going to do is we need to get these bars on the top and hold them in place while we attach this doohickey.
Okay.
So
I like that you call it a doohickey.
Yeah.
It provides me with a lot of reassurance that we know exactly
what. What is the technical difference between a doohickey and a thingamabob?
Well, it's very complicated. First of all, we're going to need more Johnson rods. I like that this one actually has a Intel side and an AMD side.
Oh, so who do I want to rep?
Well, you are ripping Intel.
All right, there we go.
And it's got to be out, so that's important.
Mm-hmm.
The next thing we have to do is fit these hexagonal bars through, but we need to do it for the right holes.
Okay.
And it looks like it's just up to the case of. Yeah.
Oh, is that what those holes are? These guys right here?
Yeah, so they're going to come up from the bottom.
All right.
So let's get started with that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's flip this whole thing right over.
Okay.
Let's find out which holes need to go where.
It's like a hard plastic.
And this is why Text and Reference suggest we do this before we get the motherboard in, but...
We too like to live dangerously.
I like to think we're doing okay so far.
Mm-hmm.
So there's where you are.
Okay.
So let's get that Intel side out.
Okay.
And just...
does it matter?
I don't think the orientation matters. There.
Okay.
So we want to see where the holes line up on the side bits. I think we found the mounting.
The closest one.
Because we've got silver bits mounting up. So it's going to be C that we want.
Okay.
On all of those holes.
All right.
So, this is going to be fun, by the way.
I like fun.
Yeah.
So is it mounting on this side?
No.
Oh, it goes in, yeah.
But this is the mounting bracket, so take a couple of those and let's stick them through C. Apparently until it clicks. I heard mine click.
Mine didn't.
Well, I can tell you why, but let me get the camera so I can show you why, too.
Okay.
The reason yours didn't click, where's my camera, is note that my screw is against the edge, whereas yours is turned just a bit.
It goes right inside of it.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice.
Now, here's what I'm thinking is, were they smart when they did this, or were they just kind of meh? No, they weren't. They were kind of meh.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, so, one of us is going to have to hold that in while the other screws the other parts in.
I like holding things.
Okay. Let's flip that over. Doesn't need too much pressure, but it's going to need some. Okay. So you got your hand under there?
Yeah.
Great. Can this be seen by... Yeah, good. We'll use the overhead camera for that. Next step is to get these mounting brackets in.
Okay.
In such a way that they work.
Okay.
All right. I like that plan.
So they need to be... Mounting bar is...
Actually, Ian, can you just quickly reach up and zoom the overhead camera in just a little bit?
Sure. There we go. Okay. Interesting. It's,
I'm just going to cough.
Yeah, because... So it says you're supposed to do it like this.
Okay.
That seems odd. Because there's a lot of stuff in the way.
Right.
This definitely isn't going to go there.
So.
But I guess maybe it does go on top? Oh, no, that's fine, because the this sits lower than the mounting bar does.
Right.
So that's why it's going to work like that. And I bet I bet these sit nicely on top of the bits, if I am correct. Yep, right. Yeah, because you're pushing back against them. It's not actually touching the bits. Perfect. Okay, time to attach some thumb screws.
Okay.
You still okay under there?
Yeah.
Great.
So those pieces actually go on top of... top of the capacitors.
It looks like it.
The dual BIOS.
That would be why there's the back plate.
Yeah.
Zerk says, for those watching at home, bigger motherboards tend to have fewer issues with crowding.
You think?
But yeah, if you're afraid that you won't be able to do this if you don't have two or three people to work with you on it, you could always get a larger motherboard.
Okay, and that's what.
Yeah.
It's going to be a
something
lot simpler.
Something snapped there.
What?
What else?
What? What? What?
Something snapped out. Okay, let's flip it up on the side. Ooh, my back. Okay. So everything's in there good and tight.
Mm-hmm.
The way we want. I see what's going to happen here.
Good. Good.
All right, T, then.
It's time to get sticky.
It's time to get sticky. Do you want to get sticky?
No.
Okay. Now, it's...
Too bad. That's what time
it is. It said we're to apply a thin layer of cryo paste, so it's barely visible.
Okay. So everybody telling me just like murder that sucker with cryo paste. That was not
you
the
you should not
should
do
not
that.
Do that.
What you should do though, according to the instructions, is remove the fan from the front of this before doing so.
Okay.
Yeah. So the objective is to use that entire tube of cryo paste.
Yeah. Somehow. I suggest eating a good portion of it.
Okay. This doesn't appear to like come off nicely.
It's going
to
be pretty tight. Unfortunately, we do actually need to remove that in order to. There we go. Close. There we go. There's a piece of... Yeah. That's where the extra pieces were. The plastic.
Right.
Or the rubber, rather. For the fan.
Okay, those are bent.
Okay. I don't think you did that.
I hope I didn't do that.
They straighten easily. There we go.
Wow. I love that it looks like a V8 engine or something.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, Ben. You're so worried.
I'm just like... It's 90% too, just like when some like if something like that happens and everyone's just like, well like fuck, like our bones.
Everything's fine.
Yeah.
Shut it all down.
And remember, as with the RAM, it's good to give the CPU a quick lick before you install it, just to make sure it sticks real well. It's like a suction cup.
Right, effect. Right. Also, a big portion of it too is because it's a it's a gift.
Your last chance. Do you want to?
Okay, do it.
All right. Okay. So what do I do?
Just a small pea-sized drop on the CPU.
Like right in the center.
Yep, and then spread it out so it's, as they say, barely visible. What do you think, Paul? Is that enough?
This is my masterpiece.
That might be a little excessive.
Okay, we can get rid of some of it. So let's take some of that off.
I call it the freak out.
Maybe about half that?
Yeah, you don't really need to spread it out too much because the
CPU will do its that job.
Yeah. Yeah, about half of that is probably like the little extra P. The body, rather, I think, is fine. That you could take the head of the statue off.
So.
Oh, it's all gone.
There we go.
Cool.
That'll be fun.
Okay. So people, do we spread it out or do we not spread it out?
You don't really need to. Because when the CPU goes down on it, it'll all squish out.
And it's pretty centered there too, so you should be good.
Okay.
Okay, so yank that warning sticker off.
Been waiting my whole life for this.
Sometimes I kind of gently, like, put the cooler kind of, like, in little circles as I put it down.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Just to make sure it's spread out.
Now the question is, which side do you want your fan to be going? Do you intend to have your panels off up top?
Well, so it stands up there. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, because, I mean, yeah, the heat will rise out. That's probably fine.
Okay. Well, it doesn't matter because it doesn't go in that direction.
Oh, okay. Well, so, I mean, I like the illusion of choice.
This is the direction you're going to want to be in. Placing it in?
You can put it in any direction you want, just don't choose wrong.
I think towards the fan is going to be good, so we can get some good dueling fan action.
All right.
And so you want to line these up with those.
Okay, and then you'll screw them?
Yeah, I can screw them for you.
Sure.
The fan is on the RAM side.
Okay, so you're going to turn it around. I would have thought you'd want it to blow directly to the fan.
Fan says fan is on the RAM side blowing towards the rear.
Okay. Why are you not...
All right, so one screwing in, okay.
Let's lift that other side up.
Yeah, so the idea is that the fan is blowing through the heatsink. It's pushing through the heatsink, not pulling.
Right.
That screw doesn't want to go through. Okay, we're going to have to take that out here.
Oh?
Yeah, that screw is bound up a bit.
Okay.
Now I want to have a look at it again, rather than forcing it.
Right.
Yeah, see, there we go.
Oh, yeah, it spreads right out, too. Oh, I see.
It should have a little play like that.
Gotcha.
But it was screwing out of the actual...
The dealio.
Do you mind if I just stick it back in?
No, do it. Get it.
And so Texans also included in your list of utilities a couple of utilities.
I can see, you can see on the webcam if
it's not engaging.
It's not engaging, yeah. There you go.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, good. I can check the levelness of it.
This is a good angle.
Yeah, this is an angle that it's really hard to see.
Yeah. I'm glad we used the webcam.
Okay. So I'd call that a good connection. You know, in engines, when you deal with this sort of thing, they tell you how much torque you should be putting on the screws.
Okay.
With the PC, it's just like, yeah, just do it.
Just get it until it's tight.
Just do it until it doesn't break.
Yeah.
If you're not broken, then it's okay. If it's broken, you've done it too much.
I mean, it's a good way to look at it.
I like this. This view, it's like I'm pretending I'm the chipset.
Yeah. It almost looks like you're in a car with the way the engine is.
I am the chipset.
It's like, yeah, it's like we're in Tron or something.
Yeah. Oh, see, my childhood dream of going inside the computer and learning the parts is coming true.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, so I assume the fan goes on now?
Yes, it does. And?
Like that, right?
Well, I'd do it that way, actually, because that means it's easier to get the cable down into where you need to go.
Right. Okay. So I'm just doing like the...
do you remember how it was before?
No.
Kind of like that. Just like that.
Oh, oh God. Oh God. Everything's wrong all
want,
at once.
Do you want another hand to hold on to that? While you get it clipped in place?
I just don't want to bend the things again like I probably did. That looks good.
The fan goes rotationally, says Lord Hosk.
Good plan. Okay. That feels on.
Yeah, it looks good to me.
All right.
And that's your CPU fan. So that connects to the one that says CPU fan.
The white one?
Yep.
All right.
It said that there should be a sticker on the fan that's facing towards the RAM now.
That is correct.
Cool.
Cool.
Just so the chat knows, yes, sticker on fan.
Ta-da! Yeah. Neat.
Go back to Tron Town. Stay out of Tron Town.
Tron Town. It's just dangerous.
Kids with their CPUs and their GPUs.
Oh, God. I got big pizza boy hands. There we go.
I like to get in there with two fingers, one on each hand, and just kind of chopstick it in.
Right. That's it. Jokes!
All righty, then. I feel like we're missing one. That's the front audio, yes. This guy here. Oop, and whatever this is. Okay. Front audio goes in that hole there. Again, there's one pin missing, so you can line them up.
Like so.
Regain 86 says that no one's hands are small enough. And she says that as a woman with very small hands.
Okay.
Not even the rain had such small hands.
That's it.
Why do you do that?
Ooh. Hi there.
Hello.
Okay.
Three Stooges. I was going to, this is very, very Russian.
I wish I had this webcam when I was setting up my computer. This is so handy to be able to be like, oh, hey, that's what that looks like.
Now, I wanted to check to see what one of those panels was. One of those sets of pins.
Yeah. Hey, original Sky Boss. Congrats on finishing your final papers.
Hey, yeah, congratulations. So this one up here, that is, that's, we don't have plugged into, that's your COM port, that's your serial port header.
Okay.
You are under the age of 30, so you will never need to worry about what that is.
was that a joke? Because like, I'm just like, oh.
It was kind of a joke and kind of not.
Right.
Really, you're also not a computer science major, so you're definitely
no. I'm just like, good, all right. I'm glad we don't have to worry about things today.
They're not often used in computers these days.
Okay.
Clear CMOS jumper. You don't need to do that because if you did, things would be bad. Just looking at the things that aren't currently connected and wondering what they might be. F panel headers.
Oh, awesome. Texan Reverend posted the spec list too. In chat.
Ah, thanks, SysFan. Buddy. That's what we're looking at.
Okay.
This seems too small to be the SysFan. It's only got three things on it. So that means there must be something... Or wait. Maybe you just only... Yep, you only use those. So this guy here.
Right.
As I thought, so that's your fan connector.
Right.
There's four pins on this header. If you look here.
Yeah.
Four pins, you know, to match that tab up with the tab on the...
I see.
The wire.
It's just this one here?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay. This is... Probably should have done before. I got big boy hands. I have no idea how I'm going to... Can this come off?
Would you like me to...
Can we take the front face off, though? Like...
I don't think so. There we go. No problems. Chopstick hands. There we go. Ta-da! I was a piano player for a while.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
No, I didn't know that.
Forgot most of it now.
Does that help with your computer yeah. building capabilities?
It helps with the chopstick hands. Okay. Jokes.
We're, jokes.
Terrible, terrible jokes. Wow, you got a tiny computer. Lovely. Right.
Is that it? That's the computer right there.
No.
No, I mean, like, that's not it, but, like, that's a computer.
Yeah, like, that's effectively a computer. You could hook up a USB drive to that, and it would
do things.
Kind of mostly work.
Okay.
Well, let's...
That's what I want to hear.
Let's add things now to make it better.
All right. Bigger is better.
Okay, let's do your hard drives.
Okay.
Starting with the crucial.
All right. This is crucial. So this is the crucial solid state. It's 275 gig solid state hard drive.
Again, a good little thing. Other hard drives are available. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that, Texas Reverend, because I dislike your choices. I'm saying that because by the rules established by the BBC, I am supposed to let people know that we're not on the BBC.
I was going to say, are we on the BBC?
Other British television networks are available.
Are they?
Yeah, ITV.
This is how I knife. There
we go. Which is why ITV in Edmonton had to change its name to Global, I believe. Oh. That and the merger.
Okay. Oh, I've got my True Image HD software activation key.
Yeah.
It's there. All right, so it's got a...
Yeah, bracket. You will not need that. I'm pretty sure.
Put it there. I've been boned by this in the past.
You've learned not to just throw things away.
So this goes into a special place. You had a nifty one of these new cases where you've got brackets for your hard drives.
Cool, cool.
And they're super cool because what you can do is just... pop it up, and pop it out.
Oh, pop and lock.
Yeah, so right. Did you get any screws with that?
No.
Well, these people are the worst. No, man. You did not.
All right.
So you'll need to use four more of your little round screws there.
All right.
And you're gonna wanna screw that guy to that guy.
I can do that.
Direction is probably not really... Yeah, use whatever direction you like.
Cool. I was gonna, cause I'm a free. I got free will and don't take shit from nobody.
Just admiring the back of your case here.
Yeah. All right. Screw number one.
It's got a
one.
Lot of foam on it. It's very spongy.
Spongy?
Yeah.
That's good. Is that like a sought after trait when you're buying PC cases?
Are you calling the back of his case fat?
Wow, listen, buddy.
Spongy.
Oh, that's also a huge thing. I'm very open for names because
for the computer.
For the computer. I felt like renaming myself personally on stream today.
Never really fit me.
I mean, you did rename yourself. Aren't your name Bengineering?
That's the thing. People have actually tweeted at me and sent comments on my YouTube where they're just like, so he just like calls himself that now? That's really weird. I'm just like, yeah. Until my parents officially start referring to me as that, it's not real. Okay, I can't get this one thing screwed, so I'm going to sit down for a sec.
Because I think you maybe took the wrong screw there.
Ah.
You want one of these guys.
The age-old truth. Never force it.
Yep.
Kate... Sorry, go ahead.
So, the suggestion is Ben J. Ineering.
It's not bad. I like it. Because Kate had... She named theirs Symmetra. Mm-hmm. So... I mean, that's pretty cool. I'm not that invested into Overwatch.
How about Zippotrix McEdward?
See, okay, so
just to get that right out there right now.
Yeah, I mean, It's only been recently where I would like, specifically when I'm doing like streaming type stuff, I was like, besides the plaid, I don't have anything directly attributed to Bengineering kind of a thing. And then it's just like, you did Zippo Tricks from Edgelord. You should really like
own that.
Like make it part of your thing. And I'm like, well, and now I'm also doing the Who the Hell Is YouTube series. Mm-hmm. So it's like, yeah, just like make it a thing. But then that brought into another problem where I'm like, should I actually make a personality and like name for this describing voice thing that I started doing, or is that just me doing a describing voice?
So
it goes in the fat part.
Go the other way around like that. Yep. Perfect.
The rad plaid machine.
Ooh, that's not bad.
I mean, it's gonna be plaid.
Like I'm personally partial to like singular words.
Was there a name of in the Lumberjack song? Was he referred to by a name at all?
Zippo Tricks McEdgelord has now shown up in the chat, by the way.
Yes, I figured.
All right.
Remember, you don't actually own it. Magic owns Chandra.
It's very true.
It's true.
Zippo Tricks McEdgelord, a registered trademark of Wizards of the Ghost.
Okay, so that's the...
So that's one drive in there.
Right.
Now your other drive goes in this handy little... these are really nifty hunka-chunkas.
Ooh. We got hunka-chunkas, we got zippity-doos.
The technical term is hunka-chunka.
All right.
Other suggestions... Plattington.
Ooh.
Ooh, Plattington Bear.
The Plattinator.
The Plattinator. I like Plattington. Plattington Bear is like sticking out for me. Why did Spunky Dog have to die? I mean, everybody died in that attack.
Oh no, that's a tiny drive. That's okay. But we don't get to use the Hunka Chunka.
No!
So you'll note that the Hunka Chunkas are too wide.
Oh, for big
drive.
Boys. Yeah, big so drive. this is a TravelStar HGST 1 terabyte. Yeah.
Rotating discs are available.
2.5 inch.
Oh, is that like it's a laptop size?
Yeah. Drive. So you get to use the other one of these things on top.
Oh,
rather
than it comes with itchy band powder.
But it means if you ever wanted to upgrade your computer's
you can
storage.
Turn into a whole file server thing. You got attendant slides there.
Okay, so we put it in the other.
It's actually that's one thing with having such a large case with a tiny motherboard is you have way space for expansion stuff.
Yeah, which is cool. So I need the other.
Get that out of there for you. And you'll probably want to make sure that that end goes towards the arrow again, just so
that way.
Yeah, just so that they're going in the same direction.
Okay, and it should be facing down, or should it be that way?
I'd face down.
Yeah.
Just so that you're protecting it.
Sure.
While you're doing
we're running low on tiny screws, but yeah.
We have four of them. You should have four of them.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
I'm wondering if there's extra space here in your machine for. Oh, I see.
Dude, I could put like a Care Bear in there. Like, there's a lot of room.
It looks like this thing here you can.
So I like the Care Bears as your way you measure space.
This is exactly four Care Bears wide. I don't know why that was the first thing that came to mind. It just did. I actually never watched the Care Bears growing up, but I know that one of them was a lion. So it was like, I think as soon as.
Okay, thank you, Heather.
What? They're cousins?
Well, it's Care Bear cousins.
That was
Care
a
Bears, and then there's Care Bear cousins, and those are the other animals that are not bears.
Right? Isn't there like a Triceratops? Or am I like way off?
I think that's biker mites from Mars.
I think you might have been watching Jurassic Park, maybe.
Possibly, probably. Gotta really set my phone.
All right. So, what were you looking at there?
Yes.
Ian?
Oh, I was looking at this thing here, because this looks like a system that you could probably bolt something on the back of to make another. Because there's space inside there where no drives live, where you could probably have a system where you could just chunk drives in.
So you could just get more sleds.
Yeah. Cool. But it doesn't look like it comes with it automatically, which is fine.
Incidentally, as some people mentioned, that those sleds probably do have mounting screws, so you could mount the small size drives in them.
I had a look at them, and yes, they do have the holes on the bottom.
But there's no particular reason why you would want to.
Yeah, like from the edges, they're.
Yeah, you would mount it from the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I keep grabbing the slightly too big screws, I think. No, wait, this is the right size.
In some ways, I miss the old. indestructible ATX steel cases of the 90s.
I feel like you just like urine in general for the times of old.
You say urine gentle in general?
Urine gently for the times of old.
You urine in general.
But I do like some old things. Some old things are bad, like the serial port.
Right.
No, there's a lot you can do with the serial port.
I'm definitely in favor of serial ATA. ATA ribbons were straight up
They were
bull honky.
Garp.
Black it says just
so
keep...
So speaking of general ATA cables, that's what I'll be using to mod the Dreamcast with.
Oh, really?
I will be snipping one end of the connector off, stripping all the wires, and soldering about half of them directly to the motherboard.
All right, so... Wow.
This is like a really complicated Dreamcast mod you're doing.
It's not the easiest, which is why the Russians charge $300 for their hardware mod versions, I think.
Cool.
Okay.
There we go.
That went in there nicely.
Nice and smooth.
Okay, so now we got to run more power.
More power.
Yep.
More power.
Nope.
It's time to battle.
Nope. Nope. Yeah, dog.
All right. I was doing some Metabots references, in case anybody got that.
Okay. So. Great. You should only need one or two of those.
This one?
Perf. One will do.
All right.
It looks like. Do the other ones do the same thing? Yes, they do. I've never owned a modular power supply before, and they seem really cool. Okay. That end. What does it say on it?
SATA.
Great. Stick it in one of the SATA ports.
Okay.
I recommend one of the top ones, just because you'll...
Now, Now, with those two SATA cables that you have, one being... No, you don't need... Not for this, but for the other cables, one being right angle and one being not.
Mm-hmm.
You'll want to be a little bit careful about which you use where.
I've got plans.
All right, good.
Which I might forget before I end up doing it, so.
Reminders are good.
Can you hold that?
Yeah.
Thanks. Did I get it? There we go. Cool. Donezo.
Great. Good. There's your phone back.
Thanks, dog.
Okay. And now you can plug this.
Also, yes. Sorry. R4V5 made a good point. I'm not really a short person. Everybody else is just really tall.
Hello.
I'm like 5'11". Like, that's not short.
We're the same. It's that, which is, I would like to point out, the... exactly average size for a Caucasian male.
Yeah.
I just also happen to be...
Which is what short people say. Yeah, but...
I also happen to be the shortest person in Loading Ready Run.
Yeah.
Well, of the guys.
Okay. Yeah.
Of the boys.
Yeah.
All right.
Good night.
Okay, so...
I don't know. Are you hired? You're taller than 5'11"?
So, that's going to go into here and here on your drives.
This is
a power slot.
That away?
Yep. It only, again, it's one of those ones that only goes in one way, so if it doesn't work...
So you never like...
That seems wrong. That seems right.
Cool.
Yeah, you might want to use the other one. Well, can you fold it in such a way that it works? No, you can't.
So probably two then?
No, actually, you just use the longer end.
Oh, neat. All right, nifty.
Get that in there, and then get this one in here.
I see a bunch of people being like, 5'11 is not the average for me.
Okay, so that's your power. Isn't it strange that your power is a bigger cable than the actual data cable?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, power requires, juice.
Need more wires.
And juice them.
So,
yeah, I mean, the actual power going through a data cable is not that much.
No.
Yeah.
Let's flip this over again.
Okay. If you've got like 220 power going through your data cable, you've got a big problem.
Yeah. Or a very long distance to go. Okay, so this is why, this is the plan I had.
Okay.
Thankfully,
are we able to...
We'll there we go. Yeah. So we have the one right angle connector.
Mm-hmm.
I figure because we have these ports right here, we can just use those ones.
Right.
And one can be a right angle connector there.
Right.
Boop.
Cool.
And then the other one can go in the other hole.
Boop.
Okay.
And then we're feeding them through.
Yep. And you might as well just use the hole that's right there.
Sure. Thanks, tiny motherboard. Might be easier to lift.
Yep. Now, as I told Kate, you're welcome to do any cable management you want after the fact.
Right. We're not doing that?
Maybe. Let's flip this around so we can show the people. And so you can do it easily.
All right. Sure. So, we got these two boys right here.
Yep. We're going to snake down.
Should I know which one goes where?
Well, actually, we can do this easier.
Yeah.
And show people easier by doing this.
There we go.
There you go. Now you can see where they need to plug into.
Yeah, and it's also easier for me. So, is it with the switchy dealy up top?
Again, they only go in one way.
And my angle. Ben was just blocking it with his head.
Sorry.
Over to your...
Why do we even have this over here?
Here.
Yep. I think it's the other way.
Oh, yeah, there are those Velcro wraps in the back there.
I think it's the other way. There we go. Yeah, we'll probably stick things into those at some point. Alrighty.
Cool.
Great.
There has been a couple of suggestions for Al Borland as a name for the PC.
Oh.
To go with the plaid scheme.
Right.
Yeah. Well, I think we're just about done. Just need to put in the graphics card now.
Okay. Cool.
So let's flip her over.
This is exciting, guys.
Okay, now before you get the graphics card in,
right,
you're going to need to open up a slot for it.
Okay.
Or a couple, actually, because you've got lots of ports there.
Right.
So grab your screwdriver.
Screwdriver.
This is where we get the Dremel.
And now you're going to need to undo these two nuts here. They're very tight, so use the screwdriver on those.
That makes sense. I don't know. Grab the screwdriver. Put it down beside the two screws that you're going to be unscrewing.
There. So this plate just lifts up.
Oh, okay. So
good night. Now rake that screw around the motherboard a bit.
Yeah. Give it that... I mean, isn't that what people pay for now? The distressed look on their motherboards?
Yeah.
Yeah, motherboards are like jeans.
Yeah. Yeah, let's just
couple of holes and stuff. It's all good.
Okay, and then you're going to want to get these two out.
Just the two?
Yeah, that one and the one.
Yes. One!
See, the other one nice thing though is if you had a normal size motherboard, those would have fallen onto the motherboard.
Yeah.
Whereas now they're just falling into the case.
Okay. Now keep those and put them in a place where you won't forget, but definitely will forget within 5 years when you need them.
Mm-hmm. Hope they don't go
Hope
they don't go through the wash.
I'm pretty sure the three PCs and the Mac that has faceplate or parts on it all have missing holes in the back of them.
For those who weren't able to see, I just put them in my breast pocket on my shirt.
Yeah.
You'll never, hey.
You're not planning on washing that shirt anytime in the next 5 years, right?
No, nah. That's fine. All right. So.
Yep.
Like this.
Yeah.
Bunk. Right?
Just right in the hole. There's a few holes you're going to want to line up, though. There you go. You got most of them.
So what you got, looks like you got two DisplayPort, two HDMI, and a DVI. Is that what's going on there?
I want to get it near until it clicks.
Okay.
You know, it's all it makes that sickening crack noise.
Yeah. All right, good.
Wait till it makes a sickening crack, and then push it a little bit more.
That's how you know it's working. Okay, so, and then I just screw them on?
Yep.
Three DisplayPort, a HDMI and a DVI.
It's, nice. It's a good combination of ports.
I know I'm going to lose this screw.
It's a good combination of ports, except for the fact that I have had enormous amount of trouble getting a just display port to display port cable.
Yeah.
Everybody's got mini display port cables.
I'm surprised we didn't see more display port or mini display port ports in PCs.
Exactly. I mean, this one actually has a mini display port in it.
Oh, the graphics card?
No, the built-in card.
Oh, this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, not Ben's, but the loading ready run PC here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's amazing.
All right.
In fact, this one might too if you look at the back. But
and unless you own or decide to buy a different motherboard, you'll never need to move this again until you change your graphics card.
Fantastic.
Right, because you don't actually have any more slots. Yep.
Okay, well, we've got a little time. Do you want to actually, do you want to do some...
cable management?
Yeah.
It's done?
You're done.
Wow,
that's
guys.
A PC.
I have a PC.
I mean, then we're going to have to... Then we'll probably do some booting and testing when we come back after a break, but let's spend 15 minutes making some cables clean.
Sure.
I'm actually going to suggest that we move these, because I thought we didn't have enough room, but we do, to go through the rubber hole.
Okay.
So let's get those out. They have a metal
Clippy.
Tab on them, the top of them. These being the SATA cables.
One.
Just so everything's going through the same holes.
Yeah.
The chat is suggesting trying to get a post before you actually do too much more.
Yeah, chat.
All right.
We're going to live dangerously. We're going to one-time this, right?
No, no whammies.
Okay, there you go.
I think really my biggest worry is that I didn't seat everything absolutely correctly.
You're not done.
All right. Tell me more, tell me more.
We forgot to plug one thing in.
Yes.
That's your power for your graphics card.
That's probably important.
Mm-hmm. Very important.
You don't actually have graphics.
The graphics card can't...
Is that this?
Nope.
The slot that the graphics card is in supplies power, but the graphics card goes...
I want more.
It so laughs at that puny power.
Is that one of these?
Well, there should be one that says something like graphics or VGA.
It says VGA on a bunch of these. It says VGA.
That's the one you want to use.
All right.
Even though VGA is a standard that's very, very old.
Yes. I mean, you have to use VGA.
So once more into the power supply.
We're literally looking at VGA on the monitor over there.
That is a port I am very happy to see die.
All right, so.
Again, it'll be marked. Right, let's turn it around.
See, it's very, as VM Kid says, it's very straightforward. That cable stands for video games awesome. And that's the cable that makes video games awesome. If you don't plug that cable in, your video games
man, that
will
goes
be
way
decidedly
back
subpar.
In there.
Yep.
Oh, good. Okay, I'm going to pull that out for a sec. Hopefully I got it the right way.
Yeah, it's the one thing, the one part of the case that you can't come in from the other direction.
I should probably turn the eco on too at some point. Is that a thing that you turn on?
Is there a switch?
There's a switch. Eco off on.
I'll leave that off for now.
Video Games Awesome is a show on Twitch.
Oh. Wow.
So
it's a great name for a show.
So close.
Hold on. I can do it, coach.
Have you got the right end? I don't think you've got the wrong end.
Fuck. All right.
Yeah, there we go. Keep going. There we go.
Yeah. All right.
Wow.
Chuck one up for Pizza Boy hands.
Okay. Stick it through the hole. Oh, hey. Let's use this hole.
Oh.
It's not doing anything.
Hold them. Yeah!
Use the hole that isn't currently busy.
And then I assume this one. Like
yep,
that.
Cool. There you go.
Cool.
Good stuff.
All right.
So.
Does that only have the one?
Yeah, just the one three-prong hole. Let's flip it over. Whew. Nanny. Okay. Messy.
Yeah. So what do we got here?
So we got these these channels for your cables. I figured let's just put as much in channels as possible.
Yeah, so it looks like some of these slipped out of the... There's little sheaths like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
So, I mean, everything's kind of going that direction, right?
Yep.
More or less. So, like...
Let's see what we can pull out. This is going down here. And then maybe over that way.
Texan says to remind Ben that TQ also gave him a roll of cable wraps as well.
Oh, yeah. That's in that bag right there. There should be a wrap of them.
Wink. Nice.
I don't know if we'll need them.
Oh, but if you do.
Yeah, they're there. It's got some nice little wraparoos. Yeah, like that.
You put one on there.
Did I do it backwards? I think I did.
I don't think it matters.
God damn it, Ian.
Look, if it goes both ways, you can take it both ways.
Then.
Yep.
All right, friendship. Just touching hands.
Get in the computer. Okay, that's out of sight, which means it is out of mind.
All right, that's the age-old saying.
There's some slack, so let's jam it down in the hole as well.
Put everything in the hole.
That one, I think we're going to stop it right there.
Okay.
That one...
I don't know if it'll reach.
Okay.
That's looking good.
Yeah.
That's looking nice. Do you wanna do the same for that guy?
Up to you. There's a lot of unused stuff here, so.
I'm just seeing how much room there is. I'm like, oh my goodness.
You can just use that thusly.
There's so much room for activities in my computer. So what are your thoughts?
I think you did a damn good job.
Oh, thanks, Coach. That's the support I always wish I had growing up. before I became a creative, I could have made something of myself.
Okay. Let's button it up.
Okay.
Because like I said,
do you want to see the top down to see?
GQ has shown up in the chat,
by the way. Hey, fam. All right.
Let's find the panel for this side.
That's there it is. It's looking nice. It's looking cable-y.
I think these wow, this is not often that case sides are symmetrical.
Nice.
You'll never see it again.
There we go. It's so pretty and sleek.
Yeah.
Not like me at all.
That's true, Ben.
Well, When it's rugged and plaid, that's me.
Made of plywood. All right. There's side two.
Ooh! That's a really good name.
Have you got your cable ties?
Yes. Someone just suggested Plaidos.
Oh.
Plaidos? I like
ooh,
that.
That's yeah. really...
That's super strong.
I think that's the winner. Whoever got Brandon. That one, please make it known. I really like Plaidos.
There we go. That's neat.
You're neat.
That was Zippotrix McEdgelord.
Zippotrix McEdgelord, my child.
Says you're welcome, all father.
You've done so much for me. All right.
Okay.
Plaidos it is. I know what you like, Father. All right, let's.
All right. So, it's up.
Ah, get its face on.
Look at this.
It's upside down. It's not magnetic.
No, you had it right.
I had it right. It's just not magnetic. Okay. There's your computer.
Wow. This is exciting. Look at this thing.
I think at this point, let's take ourselves a short break.
Yeah, and we
get the table cleaned off, and let's go to post.
Mm-hmm. So we'll see you guys in a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, we will take another commercial. Back in just 1 sec. All
right. Welcome back once again to Tinker Tailor Solder Fry, where we've just finished putting together Ben's PC. We've buttoned it all up. We've connected the power to everything and a monitor. Mm-hmm. We've got that too. It's time to figure out if she runs.
That's the big question, isn't it? I'm almost afraid to start it up.
Well, you've got the power and the power supply on there too.
Yep.
Let's hit the button.
Let's do it. Let's do it, folks. It lights up too.
Okay.
It's got a nice light up on it. It's got a nice breeze behind it.
Nice and quiet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's super good.
Not seeing anything on the monitor yet.
HDMI
1.8. Oh, flash. A cursor happened.
Hey, look at that.
Okay.
There we go.
Now we'll. I think we want to do Windows 10 setup.
Dang, guys. We did it.
Yeah.
Nice.
Congratulations.
That felt good.
Yeah.
I didn't have my phone open for chat reactions.
That is, damn. You know, considering, so this is a good test.
Yeah.
In terms of, so if you want to use this computer for streaming, we are currently streaming. Your microphone is like, what, 2 feet away from the back of the mm-hmm. computer?
Yeah, and you're not getting anything.
We're not getting anything.
That's so good.
It is a real quiet computer.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not on full load right now, but
that
still.
That was some of the other things that, Text and Reverend did also. Provide me with the same webcam that you guys use for streaming. I think it's the Logitech 1080 guy.
Or 970, I think, is the model number?
930, I think.
It's in the bottom of that bag that I just put a bunch of stuff in. But yeah, it's
930 is ours. There might be a newer one of the same version, but yeah, it's a real good.
Yeah, and then as well as a Rode. Shotgun mic, which is super, super nice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so, and I'm already digging Plateaus as the name. It's real good.
Do you have a capture box for it? Or you're playing PC games.
I do, and I found the workaround too. I play a decent amount of PS4 games on my stream as well, but I use the remote play feature on the PS4, and then you just screen cap it.
That's...
And when everything is on like a Ethernet connected network, it runs great.
You think the latency is not bad? I guess you can play it on the on like a monitor.
Yeah,
so you don't have to. It's not like you're playing it over the.
But I hadn't thought of that.
That's... Yeah, it's a really nice workaround for some of you folks who might not be able to afford.
Yeah,
a capture card.
I mean, an Xbox One has something similar. I think.
I would assume so.
Yeah.
I mean, like if anything, it's just like they have the ability just because it's all Microsoft play your Microsoft stuff on your Microsoft stuff. But it's super nice. Ah, just look at it. Look at it doing its thing,
Windows
guys.
Windows failed to start.
Well, yeah, because it's not here.
Right.
Okay.
Windows 10 30.
No, not 32.
No, definitely not 32.
So advanced options, maybe.
Hmm.
But it's trying to actually boot off the disk, not mm-hmm. install off the disk.
That's interesting. Let's reboot and see what the BIOS says.
All right.
That's not actually like the Windows. What is that USB key you have?
That's Tex and Reverend's disk that he's supplied to Kate.
Yeah.
Escape. See if you can remove that disc for me.
This guy?
Yeah.
It actually didn't feel like it was all the way in either, but.
That boot is so fast. I can't see which button to hold down. Is it F2? It's usually F2, or it's delete. There we go. Hey.
Oh, so fancy.
Okay. Wow. Dang, look at this thing. 200.
Okay.
Well, in case the stream folks need to see the dual BIOS boot up screen here. Mr. Phillips says, while we're in the BIOS, can we check the CPU temp and make sure the heatsink is on properly?
Yes, we maybe can.
Yes, we'll see.
System information. CPU temperature, 34 degrees Celsius, which...
That is very nice.
Seems fine.
Cool.
Everything...
I remember one of my old computer... Once it got up past 70 degrees, it was not good. I think they're rated up to higher than that even. But if you start getting up in that area, then that's not so good. 34 degrees is positively balmy. It's just kind of a warm day in Texas.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I would not be happy in that.
No.
But. Granted, I'm the person that gets, like, unhappy in temperatures above, like, anything above 18. And it's getting into, like, hot town for me. I like it to be cool. I'm a warm person.
Okay, I've set up the boot to the crucial first.
R4 says the SSD is not visible in that list of drives, but I think I saw it.
Yeah, stick the drive back again.
All right.
There may have been a problem with.
I don't think you put it all the way in. Maybe.
Nope. Shouldn't have got to the.
You're right.
Ian, can you please tell the chat that you connected that cable?
Oh yeah, the SATA cable the SATA power cable that people kept screaming about in the chat. I didn't end up connecting.
Yeah.
It wasn't what I thought it was. It was something different. I still don't know what it is, but it's now connected.
It said Windows 10 setup there instead of just boot Windows 10.
Ah, there we go.
I think this is different and better now.
Cool.
Let's hope so.
Yeah.
As long as we don't get the run Windows nurgmully command. When Windows, it's a screen cap I've seen of a Windows really failing very hard.
Do we want to give another shout out to these lovely people on the front there?
I think we should, yeah.
Yeah.
Once again, this table protected by Wormwood. They make excellent other products which you should actually buy. And if you choose to buy from Wormwood, some of their lovely game deck boxes, dice towers, dice rolling things, dice vaults, etc. You can get free shipping if you use the code LRR. In the U.S., but if you live outside the U.S., use the code LRRWORLD for $10 off your shipping, and we get a cut of that.
Yeah, we get the. I was gonna be like, we get a shout out, but it's a monetary shout out.
Well, everyone gets a little taste.
Yeah,
you know, get your beak wet.
Some hashish. But
so, what do you plan? That's interesting. Oh, that's from the solder. Okay, good.
That's from a past endeavor.
Oh, that's a pin. That's necessary. No. So what do you plan to be streaming first with this thing?
Streamed first. One of the games that like we were talking about it earlier. I'm gonna be the worst like theme dude for this. But there's a game that most recently just came out into beta called. Gigantic, Go Gigantic. I cannot remember the actual title, Become Gigantic, Gigantic. It's kind of like a Smite-style MOBA kind of game. But some folks may recognize some familiar names on that, like Amy Falcone.
Go Gigantic.
Thank you. And it looks really, really cool. Just went into beta, and it's kind of by Super Friends. And my biggest thing is I've never been able to stream multiplayer games because it's just too much for my laptop to handle. Really, the main thing, the beautiful part about this was TQ and I were talking about it the other day, and they were like, yeah, we can play this game. And for once in my life, ooh, I didn't have to go, I'll have to look at the spec sheets for that one, because I'm fairly confident that Plados can run it. So
Tex Norman was kind enough to supply me with your Windows code, so we might as well just enter that in right now for you.
All right.
Yeah, let's turn that away from the window. Let's not look at that.
Yes, the exact opposite.
Maybe turn the screen a bit.
There we go.
Yeah, and it's an open beta right now, so if you want to try it out, definitely try it out.
No, don't look at that. Wait,
Just look at my face. Well, you don't look right here. Yeah, everybody, here. Check it out.
Here. Look at Ben's face.
All right.
This sounds like a really cool game, guys. I'm excited for it. You should be excited for it, too. Sometimes I go to sleep thinking about this game. And the number one thing when I wake up and I look my roommate in the face who says, you want some breakfast? I look at him and say, go gigantic. And then he makes me a big breakfast. I don't know. All right. Did we activate it?
It's
thinking about
timing.
It.
I'm going to bring up my
Does
watch.
Does it need a network in order to do that?
You know, you're probably right. No, I think it should store the key.
Oh, you can boot. You can install no problem, and then it'll try to activate.
It's still hung. I need to look. Yeah. Looking entertaining.
Okay, now we need to do a custom install, right? I can never remember. Do we need to do we need to do a custom install.
Yeah, you can't upgrade the
users. Yeah, that's
there.
Right.
So we're going on to drive one, which is the SSD.
And we need to format it. Format.
Will I be playing the Overwatchman? I would love to play Overwatch on stream. Just like in general, I've never been able to stream multiplayer games.
Oh, no.
So being able to do friend times and stuff like that. Another thing that I really wanted to try out is apparently emulators like Dolphin.
Oh yeah.
Enable you to play online with friends and stuff like that. So I used to do a stream called Monday Night Mario Parties. Where I would just invite a bunch of different friends and whatnot, and we would play Mario Party and answer questions and do funny things.
Dude, I am excited for that.
So yeah, maybe, and that was the thing. Also, Dolphin was too powerful. GameCube emulations were too much for my laptop. Mm. So I'm excited to be able to do those as well. Because there are a number of Nintendo games, and just games in general, that I've never really been able to I never played, like Wind Waker. I've never played through any of the Banjo-Kazooie games, like Chrono Trigger, like all these like really important games that like I need to play that make me
No more heroes.
Like fake nerd boy kind of a thing.
Didn't realize we were going to reveal our nerd sense tonight.
Yeah. So,
Actually, something that you might want to check out that I have learned from my own experience with stuff with the streaming, especially since you're doing the sort of single computer streaming.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we can look at it once Windows is installed. But in the BIOS, when you have a external graphics card like you do, because it is much better than the internal graphics than the built-in graphics card on the Intel processor.
Mm-hmm.
It deactivates the internal graphics of the Intel processor.
Right.
But you can turn that back on so that it can be used in order to do the actual streaming.
Mm-hmm.
So there's Intel has a function. I have just been informed that of course, this is a Xeon processor.
The CPU does not have on-chip graphics.
Does not have on-chip graphics.
However, you have a Xeon, so you shouldn't have a problem with horsepower for your streaming.
Yes, yeah.
So there is actually a couple different ways of doing it, but one thing you can do, though, is in OBS or XSplit or whatever you're using to stream, there should be a function to actually use... To use hardware encoding with your from your graphics card, GeForce has a thing called NVEC or something that does that. So you should look into that because I mean, your CPU is going to be fine for whatever you want to do on this guy, but it's nice, especially if you are running like a bunch of different stuff at once, then you don't have to worry about the stream itself taking a chunk of your CPU.
Yeah, definitely.
So to give you a rundown of what you got here, too, Texan Reverend has given you the open release version of Photoshop CS2.
Whoa, wait, what?
Well, open release.
Okay,
They released the legacy versions.
Right, yeah, I didn't know there was... But yeah. Wait, there's more situation going on here.
There's a hardware monitor to keep your eye on temperature during the first few boots, so keep your eye on that.
This is what's on this USB key?
Yep. Portable versions of Clam, Win, Antivirus, and Spybot, which only run when opened, which is important for a streamer because you don't want that stuff going up when you...
Yes.
I'm working on. Anti-Beacon, which disables all the phone home data mining built into Windows 10. And StarDock, which provides a more familiar and usable start menu. And some regedits to make the older Windows Photo Viewer available to set as a default program. As well as instructions for disabling sign-on on Wake Up and Windows Lock Screen and Windows Updates.
Fancy.
Wow. Thank you so much. And once again, like a huge shout-out to Texan Reverend, who has been a huge supporter of myself as well as... all of Learn, really, like, just especially, specifically Tinkle Tailor Solders.
Tinkle Trailer Solder Fly.
Fly. The spin-off series.
Wow, that's, what can we do there? I mean, it's, urinary mods. Experimental aircraft.
Anyways, I do like how the Wormwood and the background really line up nicely, but yeah, he's fantastic. He's a huge supporter of all the stuff that we do, so it's really nice having you around. So thank you so much. And yeah, we're sitting at about 53% for installation, getting the files ready for installation.
Another question. Point of order from the chat.
Right.
Do not completely disable your Windows updates.
Right.
Do make sure to do them, just disable them so they're not done on, not sure, popping up on stream.
Yeah, yes. I mean, I've never really had an updates issue in the past,
Windows 10 has a bad habit of being like, you know what, you need an update right now.
Yeah, like knock, knock, open up the door.
It's Windows 10. Heather and I actually had that problem on one of our streams that it decided it wanted to shut us down.
Right.
Thankfully, we weren't streaming at the time, but it was when we just finished.
Oh, okay.
And Windows said, okay, now it's time to shut down.
Right.
So annoying. It did before stream 2, and I had to do setup.
Yeah. Is this Windows 10 Pro, asks Bear Squad Go. That's a Texan question.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, if you guys have any other questions and whatnot, I mean, this is definitely the time to ask. We've got a little bit of time going on here right now. It can be about literally anything. I'll answer anything.
Oh, will you?
Oh, I mean, I'm not gonna get. This is a family friendly stream, so I'm not gonna get too down and dirty.
Texan Reverend said this is Windows 10 Pro.
Oh wow, so. What's the difference between Pro and regular?
You get to say that you have the Pro. There are legitimate versions.
No, man. I bragging rights. I'm all about that. I'll pay that extra $50 to say I'm a Pro. But
I'll look that up.
Yeah, it's good. So we can look like we know what we're talking about.
Yeah.
People are talking about Windows updates right now. To Dr. Bengineering, what's the next? When is the next? Who the heck? Who the hell is going up on youtube.com/BengineeringZone? So that's my brand new YouTube channel/show that I started doing. For any of you who might not have seen it, if any of you are Desert Bus fans and you like the Describe and Magic characters voice that I did, I started up a brand new series where I do that. This first episode was all about Zarya, or as I like to call her, Beefcake McSpunky Hair. And if you want to check that out, you can go to youtube.com/BengineeringZone, where it's going to be all of my random projects and stuff that I do. The next one is, it's either going to go up during Christmas times or after Christmas, just because this is a really weird, like, I'm leaving to go back to my hometown on Thursday, so I might not be able to have it done. But I will say, the next character is from the last time I checked the polls and the voting, the next character is most likely going to be Steven Universe.
Ooh.
So yeah, look forward to that one.
So I've got an answer for you about what Pro does.
Tell me more.
So Home and Pro have both customizable start menus, Windows Defender and Firewall, Hibernate and Instant Go, Cortana, Windows Hello, Virtual Desktops, Snap Assist, Continuum and Edge Browser. But Pro gives you device encryption, domain join, group policy management, BitLocker, remote desktop, client Hyper-V, and a max RAM of 512 gigabytes over 128 in the home version.
Oh, I didn't know software restricted your RAM stuff.
That's, I guess, something that Windows decided needed to happen.
Interesting. Well, I mean, I don't have a worry of it now, so that's good
you
to know.
You can have all the RAM you want. As long as it'll fit in two slots.
Yeah.
It's going to be fine for what you're doing.
Got that good hardware encryption, though.
Mm-hmm.
Have you considered any party games for your streams, like the You Don't Know Jack series? Yes.
Mm.
I like You Don't Know Jack. I hear there's a really good new one with the t-shirts.
Yes. Yeah, I can't remember the name of that one now, but that's...
Yeah, I don't know what it's called. It looks really good. Is that where because it was the Cards Against Humanity stream that did the Fill This Man With Cream thing, yeah, which I got a shirt of.
Well, what was your first Jack?
My first, the first time I actually got to play Jack was literally maybe like a year ago.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and it was the one that literally everybody plays, the Quiplash?
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah, that's the thing, is like, I recall seeing floppy disks with You Don't Know Jack, because I think it's at least old.
It was on CD-ROM.
CD-ROM, okay, yeah. I remember seeing them around the house, but I think it was beyond my childhood mind to know, so. So yeah, it was only recently, but I really enjoy playing it. I think it's one of the coolest things is it's a lot like Cards Against Humanity in the sense that you definitely need to try and play to the people that are in the room,
mm-hmm.
kind of a thing. Like, you know, certain people are really into like that dirty toilet humor, so like that's where you want to go. Whereas like for example, like whenever I play like Cards Against Humanity, if you make a logical response to whatever I play, that's the answer. I'm like, yeah, all right, cool.
Exactly.
Or if it just like fits linear, like if you have like a, you know, the Nicolas Cage card and somebody plays bees, that's instantly the winner. Doesn't matter how funny the other ones are, the bees one instantly goes, right? So, yeah. Answering more, we're at 96%.
Of getting the files ready for installation.
Yes, right, and then it needs to install.
Thankfully, you're on it.
Why weren't the files already ready?
Oh, wow, it just did it. It just installed those features.
It installed the features and the updates.
Just now. Like, literally.
That's good.
In 2 seconds.
That's good. It would be a shame if you didn't have your the features.
There.
What is Windows without its features?
Yeah.
And it's an interesting philosophical.
It's now restarting.
Well, I believe it's graphics and gameplay and value? Value.
Value.
Yeah.
Value.
Oh, hey, there we go. Now you're on an SSD. So yeah, this is going to be your first computer with an SSD in it, too.
That is like booting up lickety-split.
Oh, well, everything.
So what are some, like, people have been like, well, obviously the stuff you want to boot up faster.
Mm-hmm.
What are, for example, some things that, like, Lur likes to install on, like, the SSD?
I mean, the SSD, like, depends on what you're doing. Mm-hmm. So obviously, yeah, all your OS stuff is going to be on your SSD.
Right.
If you, you generally don't have to put, like games or like, Steam installs and stuff. You don't usually have to put on the SSD. For us, we do, like, we try to do, like, current editing projects.
Mm-hmm.
On SSD, and then older stuff we move over to the spinning drives.
Okay.
Because SSD is going to give you the max, you know, the most speed you can possibly get.
Yeah. Right. So then, like, you would put, say, like, because you guys use, like, Final Cut, for example, for editing purposes. Would you put Final Cut on the standard hard drive?
All of your apps, mm-hmm. generally, I would put on your SSD.
Right.
Yeah.
Because it's going to be pulling all the data from
there. So, like, for instance, Photoshop,
mm-hmm.
You can put your Photoshop and also your Photoshop scratch disks on the SSD.
Right.
And that's going to keep you going nice and fast.
In fact, if you wanted to be really fancy, before every stream, you might want to install the game you're playing on the SSD.
Oh, and then potentially...
Yeah, and then you're still like shuffling... I mean, the only actual... Usually the only effect of the SSD for like a game will be it'll load up faster. Once you're actually in the game, there shouldn't be any issues. But something like Photoshop or... non-game software, especially high-performance software. So anything video editing, graphics editing, that kind of stuff.
Yeah,
if you can put it on the SSD. You do want to be a little bit careful, I guess, in terms of managing your SSD. Like, for instance, if you stream, and if you are streaming like us, where you're archiving your streams, make sure that archiving is not happening onto the SSD. SSD. Because the SSD, you know, the space on the SSD is the premium.
Though you do have a pretty beefy SSD.
Yes.
It's not huge, but it's a good size. So, Ben, would you like to personalize your speech typing and inking input by sending contacts and calendar details along with other associated input to Microsoft?
No.
Would you like to send typing and inking data to Microsoft to improve recognition and suggest platform?
No.
Would you like to let apps use your advertising ID for experiences across apps?
No.
By experiences, you mean ads.
Yeah. And would you like to let Windows and apps request your location, including location history, and send Microsoft and trusted partners some data location?
No.
Okay. How about browser protection?
Oh, my goodness. Let's continue on.
Let's go with no for sending information to Microsoft. Smart screen, probably okay. Connectivity, automatically connect to suggested open hotspots, nope. Connect to networks shared by your contacts, nope.
Really?
Hi.
Oh, hi. Oh, it's talking to us.
Hi.
Hi, Plat.
We're setting things up for you.
This is the official voice of Platos.
Getting critical updates. Do not turn off your PC.
Don't you dare turn me off. I'll be back in a moment. I gotta go have a smoke out back. Just a moment.
That was a moment.
Sticky keys, just no.
Oh.
Gilbert Godfrey sets up a PC. Well, this was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And I felt like I learned things. I definitely do not think that I would be able to do this on my own at all.
Mm-hmm.
But it's been fun. It's been a very enjoyable experience.
Yeah, we did a very good we did a good thing.
Yeah, I mean it booted up.
Yeah.
Like right off the get go.
Who owns this PC? My work owns. I own it.
It's mine.
Ooh, make it yours. Skip this step.
Probably good for now. Okay, so who's gonna use this PC?
I think you do have to enter this information.
All right. All right, let's not show off my passwords.
Yeah. Let me go back to this.
Here, I can put it back on Ben's face again.
But then people might know his password just from looking at his
yes.
face.
Right, yes, this is Ian's
face.
Then they'll know his password from the way Ian reacts to Ben putting in his password.
Oh, actually, wow, that is Ben's password.
What?
I'm kidding. I'm joking.
I was like, I thought this was pretty good. This is like a computer-generated one and everything that I always use. Oh, God.
I wasn't even looking at it.
The password's not required.
I'm gonna put, for the suggestion, Ian disagrees with this.
This is...
Yeah, password. No password is required if you don't want it.
Nah, I generally like to.
Don't trust your roommate?
I mean, Maymay is a good roommate. He actually, we were talking about this earlier, my roommate and I are planning on moving to a bigger and better place eventually. And he's actually been like, I'm looking at places that have offices so that you have a streaming office to do stuff. And I'm like, wow, that's really thoughtful of you. So
apps are getting set up.
This won't take long.
So I wanted to put this up. This was, so a couple months ago, I upgraded the computers here at the office to Windows 10, or some of them.
Right.
And this was what greeted me when I came back after doing the upgrade. Thought I'd put this up here. It says, all your files are exactly where you left them.
It's like, I don't believe you.
Ooh.
And it's like, I should fucking think so.
If it said anything else, that'd be the suspect thing.
Yeah.
We heard
sticky note on people in people's rooms.
We've analyzed that you were pretty bored at your computer, so we've spread your files out in various locations.
That'd be the first ever game you get to play on Windows 10 is Find My Files.
Go find
yeah.
it.
Yeah, yeah, it's literally Windows 10 being everything is fine.
Yeah. But gonna let's start.
Ding ding ding.
Yay, look
that's
at this.
That's incorrect.
What?
Oh, you got a
yes.
wide screen, and your screen's not wide.
Oh yeah, your resolution is set wonky.
Because you don't have the graphics drivers installed yet.
Oh.
I don't know. Think those are on the thing.
All right.
This is the problem I've run into occasionally.
Mm-hmm.
Is that you'll do this, and then you're like, oh, okay, I'll just have to install the graphics drivers. Oh wait, it doesn't have the drivers for my. For my network card.
What's going on?
So these are all the things that that Texan suggested that you have.
Oh, okay.
And the installers for Photoshop, to games, and...
Bad on that setup. Oh, wow. Yeah. You know me so well, man.
And so here's the instructions on the things here, too. So I guess we can copy those over.
Sure.
They're not the latest, but they'll update later.
Oh, yeah.
Except for the Kate key. Kate OC key, don't steal.
Perfect. All right. Well, thanks again, Texan Reverend, for setting me up, man.
I suppose we can get your driver here, too.
Ashiok Nightmare Beaver says, no, you torrent.
And of course, as is tradition, the first thing, or one of the first things you do is open up Edge for the one and only time so you can download Chrome. Yeah.
In case you're interested, hackers are wanted. Go be a hacker for NVIDIA.
You got the 1060, right?
I got that 1060 shit. I don't remember what it is.
Search.
Probably.
Download. Agree.
There we go.
376. It's a good thing that we have a good internet here in the...
Go ahead and get that Chrome shit, too, eventually. We don't need to do all the... Yeah. No, James, Firefox is way worse than Chrome.
Yeah, wow, I'm disappointed in you, James.
You're like 100% wrong.
Okay, we'll get you that... We'll let you copy that over on your own time.
Yes. It's true, Edge is a fine... Like, Microsoft Edge is actually a fine browser as long as you don't want any... extra stuff, like it doesn't, you can't install any extensions or anything in it, so it's a very sort of bare bones browser, but it works for what it needs.
It's fine. I'd probably put it number three in terms of the browsers I would use.
Is the second Safari?
The first Safari, second would be Chrome, and third would be Edge.
And Safari on Windows isn't really an option.
No, and I don't use...
Technically it is, but it isn't.
I have a phone. I have an Apple computer. Syncing of tabs.
Yeah.
I mean, it does that for Chrome and stuff, right?
It does?
Especially, well, I mean, I guess you guys are Apple users, right? Like, I have a Android phone, right? So the Google Chrome
that's
is
the thing.
Fantastic.
Until I can tell my iPhone to open every link in Chrome.
Yeah.
It's kind of not going to happen.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, well, you got 2 minutes and 24 seconds left in the download. So, Paul, why don't you load up those lovely people who have decided to assist us in our endeavors by supporting us on Patreon.com and specifically on here, the stream.
Once again, a shout out to Texan Reverend again for this whole shebang. Mm-hmm. So amazing, as always.
Alrighty, let's take a look. We got quite a few subs, as you might guess.
Do you want to give it a start, Ben?
Sure, alrighty. Let's do it.
Here we go.
Bum ba da bum. It's MoD42 for 3 months. Welcome. That's as long as I've been in Victoria for.
That's true. And Selectone.
Wait, these are old ones. These are from Checkpoint. Let's try this again.
Selectone. Okay. Well, are we still?
Is this
old?
It?
Yeah, one sec.
Holding on.
Standing by.
Freeze.
I mean, those people are also awesome.
Also, you're still great. We just said you already, but you're still amazing.
All right, let's try this now. Here we go. Everybody ready?
All set. Paul Dienhart is a brand new Patreon supporter. Thank you so much. but putting food on the table.
Wordnai has subscribed for 36 months. Thanks you, Wordnai. I assume that's Scottish in some way.
The Mana Leak for 9 months. How is Sub Babby formed? Congrats on your child. Treat it right.
Ralph the Llama has subscribed for 4 months saying, let's build that PC. We did.
Indeed we did. It's R4V5, my man, for 13 months. It's a Ben and a PC. Hi, Ben. Hi, PC. Also, hi, Ian.
Indiana Joe 3 for 9 months. A torn rotator cuff is no way to start Christmas break. I'm so sorry, Indiana Joe 3.
Godoff Muffin for 29 months. Safety third. That's almost 3 years.
Dr. Loy has subscribed for 36 months. Computron hype.
That is
thank
3 years.
Thank you, Dr. Loy.
The Moat Man, I'm friends with you on Twitch for 27 months. Ben, Saturday night was one of the most joyous days of my life. I hope it was for you too.
Doc Tower is a new subscriber.
Welcome.
He went to Tower School for 7 years.
Suffix, brand new Victoria Denizen for 40 months. 40 months? That's actually longer than I expected. Hashtag plaid PC.
G Dwarf has subscribed for 32 months, saying absolutely nothing. Silence is golden. Thank you, G Dwarf.
It's the friendly neighborhood GM. For 8 months, you almost have a baby. Hang in there.
I know that guy who subscribed for 21 months.
I just realized that iPad is doing it now, so we don't have to look around. That's brilliant. Secret Pipesman for 8 months. The password is fiduciary.
Ooh.
You shouldn't have put that in your thing, though.
Feistermine has subscribed for 3 months. What did the NJ say about Johnson Rods? Well, they exist.
Stampysaur, the stampiest dinosaur around, is a brand new subscriber. Welcome to the channel. I hope you had fun.
Sir Octopus, box building, bringing back good memories. Can't wait for more Bengineering streams in 2 months. When's your next one? Who knows?
Draxoff is a brand new subscriber. Welcome to the channel. You got to see this sweet, sweet Plados come to life. I'm glad that you were here.
Star Chaser Deoxys
nice,
is a new subscriber.
A Pokemon.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, that's a Pokemon.
I wish I knew.
Woken Click, you were sleeping before, but you've awoken and you've clicked on something for 16 months. That's almost a Venetian year.
Karn Evil has subscribed for 30 months. Your files? Why wouldn't you want them? Don't worry about them.
Schnopsy, you're a clever way of saying schnapps. Windows 10, the Everything's Fine edition.
I'm doing this. Dix is subscribed for 40 months. Slipping under the wire, new PC. Hype! Thank you, Dix.
Thanks, Dix.
And thank you all for those 3,104 bits. The Flamin' Five.
Ear the Nun.
Hard Hosk.
Rock Pusher.
Northos.
Jade Warrior.
Dark Morford.
Delta V.
R4V5.
Sandwichlet.
Hot Liquid Jello.
Language is my homie.
And Elemental Alchemist, thank you so much for
the bits.
The bits.
The bits.
So.
Man, that was coordinated as fuck. So I was like, we've been doing this for a while. Working together, friendship.
Ah, good times. So with that, that's it for Tinker Tailor Soldier Fry for tonight. Coming up next on the Loading Ready Run Video Entertainment Network is New Day Tuesday, which is, help me out, Paul.
It's actually should be very cool because Cam and Ben, I believe, are going to be playing the pre-release of the new it's called Torment. I forget what the subtitle is, but the Kickstarter game by Obsidian, by the guys who did Planescape Torment. Yes, that's a good point.
I got that.
And it is going to be earlier than normal.
That's important to know.
If you look at let me just double check that is in the calendar.
Oh, 10 a.m.
Yeah, Torment Tales of Numeria. That's it.
I assume that's G being like, surprise, Ben, Cam wanted to start early because I was asked literally 2 hours ago to be on. And I was like, sure.
No, and so, it's going to be, we're going to start at 10 a.m. At least Cam will be there at 10 a.m.
I'll be awake.
Ben will be there at some point.
Yeah.
And so check that out. It should be super fun.
So that's what's coming up next here. That's also where you'll be able to see next Ben, which answers two questions we had. So until then, thank you so much for watching tonight. We will see you again next time on Tinker Tailor Soldier Fry, which will be 3 weeks from now. We doubled up on Tinker Tailor so that Ben could get his PC next Monday. Beej and I will be returning to the land of Japan for more Yakuza, and then we'll do another round of Yakuza before coming back for Tinker Tailor Soldier Fry in January with more special guests. Stay tuned. Until then, thanks so much for joining us.
This has been a blast, guys. Yeah. We'll see you later.
Ever forward, ever learning.